All right, guys, welcome to another bonus episode of SBR06. This is going to be the non-playable characters. Now, just like with the other games, we're going to be doing a non-playable character tournament where we watch and see who is the best NPC in SBR06. Now, something to point out here, I know some people might say, like, you know how, like, Maven and Luther Reigns were discovered from the betas? They are not included in here because this is a representation of stuff on a retail disc. I'm thinking about doing a, like, another bonus thing where, like, I restore them and then show them off. Which I've already kind of done that in a video where I explore the beta, and apparently there's more characters out there that just aren't publicly available. So I don't really know what the future holds for that, but just to be clear, the non-playable characters on the retail game disc is what we're covering here. So who are the non-playable characters? Well, great question. Let's get into it. So good thing about 06 is this is the first WWE Ux game where when you enable them, they just appear on the menu. We don't got to do any nonsense like replace people and stuff like that, or like cheat codes like we did for Rumble Roses. But let's go through our NPC list. So first up, we got Brian Hebner. So he's got Death Valley Driver and Sambo Suplex. We got Earl Hebner. Dudley Dog is his finisher. Take note of the overalls here too. So Eric Bischoff got Guillotine as a finisher apparently. Jerry Lawler, 76 overall. Jesus, my throat. He's got a moveset, it looks like. Jim Ross, DDT, and Combination 6. What? 58 overall. Look at all these fives. My God. We got Coach. He's got Inseguri and Headbutt 5. Lilian Garcia, DDTs. Michael Cole, Shining Wizard, Figure 4. You already know. You already know. But he's only 58 overall. I hate to see it. Tazz, 85 overall. With moveset. That might be my pick. We got Teddy Long with his spears. It says they gotta be a groggy opponent. The player is running. Interesting. Tony Chimel, and just like in the other games, they always spell his name wrong. It's one M, not two. So he's got Moonsault and Northern Lights Suplex. We got Mr. McMahon. Mr. McMahon tier 77 overall, Low Blow and Stunner. Now, these NPCs are unlabeled in the game, and I thought about labeling them so I can keep track of better of who's who. But I have a notepad where I keep track of them. So let's talk about who the NPCs are. So the first one is going to be Backstage Guy 1, as I call him. They're unlabeled in the game, so I'm just calling them. They're not officially called this, but just Backstage Guy 1 or Staff 1, wherever you want to call him. He's got DDT and Pile Driver. And then next up, this is the Bartender. Now, interesting fact about her. In one of the beta copies of the game, her stats actually do have a name. It says Bartender. But in the retail game, they just deleted it, and she has no name, so... Interesting fact for you. 33 overall, Dominator and Powerbomb. And then up next, this is going to be the Green Moveset Man. He's 45 overall. Neckbreaker is the finisher. Now, interesting thing about these three NPCs. Normally in this game, the Backstage Guy and the Green Moveset Guy have alternate attires, technically. So Backstage Guy 1 has... three variants. There's Backstage Guy 1, Backstage Guy 2, and the guy that's in the bar, like, playing pool, you know? They're all under the same superstar ID, just alternate attire. So what I decided to do is separate them, so they're not considered one guy. So we got Backstage Guy 1, 2, and the bar guy. I put them in the no model slot because I thought it would be interesting to show them all off rather than just keeping them all the same. So that applies for the moveset guy as well. So the green moveset guy, the red moveset guy, and the moveset woman are all one superstar ID, but I separated them. I masked all the stats on them and movesets, so they're basically the same, just different models. So as I said here, we got Backstage Guy 2 with the DDT pile driver. We got red moveset guy, I think this is. Or no, this is Bar Brawl guy. Pile driver DDT. This is red moveset guy with neckbreaker. And then this is the green moves woman. And those are our NPCs. So we got a tournament bracket here. I'll pull it up real quick. We randomized the seeds like last time. We're playing on hard difficulty right now. We might adjust that as the tournament goes on, but right now it's on hard difficulty. So I'm going to make a prediction here. Now, I've been recording these three NPC tournaments back to back in a live stream, and I'm 2 for 2 in my guessing here. So I'm going to say I'm picking Tazz for the win here. That's my pick. So let's see if I can pull off the 3 for 3. So we're going to start off with a single match. It's going to be Tony Chimel versus the Red Moveset Man. So this should be quite interesting. I guess this is going to be a single match, or... You know what? Let's open up with a main event match. Let's not do a single match. It's going to be a... It can't be a Slobberknocker. Hardcore match. All right. I'm fine with that. Okay, that's not... The Big Show is not in this. You are, in fact, playable, sir. Okay. The only thing about not labeling them is that I had to refer to my list here. This should be Red Moveset guy. Now, like I talked about how they have alternate attires. You can see, like, when you select those guys. Like, they're labeled with the Fulfill Your Fantasy attire names, but, you know. Let's just randomize our arena here. SmackDown. Okay, great. Lands back on SmackDown. All right, and they have no menu poses here, so rip them. Interestingly, though, in the beta copy of the game, all the NPCs have the Rocks menu pose, where in this, they just have nothing. But here we go. This is going to be our first match of the tournament. Yeah, this goes. This tournament might last a while because it's 06, but we'll see. But I got the time, so it's all right. Listen to that crowd. This is Michael Cole. Opening up with a missed elbow. Very nice. And there you go, Chimel. They're already going crazy, and the action has been yes, all the NPCs do not have entrances, so they're unmodified in that sense, so I did not change it or add entrances to them. I thought he was going for that chair, but nope. I guess depending on who, if they're clean or dirty, might help them in certain matches, too. Also, let me know if I should slightly bump up the audio. Maybe I should. It looks all right, but I think maybe it can go up a little bit. Does Vince have an entrance? I don't recall him having one, but I guess we're gonna find out. Right, come on, Red. Yeah, I agree. Red is the underdog. He's always taking abuse in the moveset. Like, just think about it, he didn't normally have red skin. The reason why his skin's red is because he's been slammed on the mat for years by Green. Oh, there, this is what I like to see. This is what I like to see. Grab the chair. Here we go. Here we go. There you go, Chimo. Going for the chair again. Oh my god, but of course 06 has these incredibly slow weapon swings. Looks like he's going for another weapon. Red isn't messing around, alright? I respect it. Barbed wire 2x4, Barbie is here. Oh my god, the weapon swings in this game are so goofy. I hate how they slowed him down from SVR. Well, I think actually in a video I talked about how you could potentially argue it's slowed down for balance sake. Like, because it makes sense, right? These do heavy damage, so like it's harder to hit them, where in the other games it was fast. But I don't know, I just don't like the slow weapon swings. And it's kind of funny because in 06, sometimes watching matches takes a while, so we might have to... We might have to go to the ladder match a bit here, but we'll find out as we go on. No doubt that SmackDown's just head and shoulders better than Raw. I couldn't agree more, Taz. Raw has some incredible superstars. All right, how many missed swings have we had here? Oh my god, there we go. That's connection right there. This has got to stop. Oh my god. All right, Chimel's got a yellow head. Yeah.
I certainly don't envy the referee in this match. No kidding.
Yo, Red's going for another weapon. You know what? I like this strategy. Oh my god. That 2x4 could inflict a serious injury here.
Yeah, I don't know why Cole always had Muda's moveset. Like, yeah, it could, like you're saying, could be like a, either like an Easter egg or a joke or what. I don't know. Like I said, if I ever got an interview with all these Yuke's employees, that would be on the list of things to ask. Is there a reason for that or what? Keeps connecting with that chair, this is going to be a real short match. And of course, you know, add in the list, why is Chimel's name spelt wrong in every game he appeared in? I mean, I guess that you could argue, like, you're not supposed to be using these people, so it doesn't matter what their names are. By God! What a counter that was! Alright, come on. I'm cheering for Red here. Alright, there you go, Chimel. The more I watch this match, the more I'm thinking that there's some legitimate person. It's kind of funny, because, like, Rumble Rose and SmackDown 2 were so quick, this is going to be slowed down a lot more. They spent the better part,
and there's the reversal. Chimel with the flip over. All right, I respect it. Oh, God. Chimel going to steal one here? He's got no damage, though. He's got to do more damage before he can get a three count.
I don't know. Part of me is I'm starting to. I think maybe I agree with turning up the damage on environmental things, weapons, and finishers. I think I agree with that. I mean, we only have one match, so maybe I'm jumping to conclusions here. Tears shed in that ring
over the years. And if these superstars have their way, there's going to be a lot more shed here.
All right, just keep missing. Look how goofy this is right now. I love 06, but I don't really like the AI in this game. Like, there's so many things to point out about it. All right, ring bell under the ring. I always thought that was weird, too, in this game. Like, why is that under the ring?
I'll tell you, anyone
is that a spare ring bell or what? They should get in
the
ring with these superstars.
I don't think anyone would last too long.
Also, I'm guessing these guys are both clean because they don't seem to be getting that much momentum from weapon swings. Yeah, I think we're going to definitely have to mix in a fair amount of ladder matches. Assuming, like, even if those are even quick in this game, the computer goes crazy. My God! Reminds me of my old ECW days. Wow! Great reversal. Great Paul Burchill. Was he going to steal one? I think he's got an orange head. Oh, gets out immediately. Wow. I can imagine. Enough, yeah, I think we're definitely turning up the damage on those. Should I do max or just a little bit, though? I haven't touched sliders in this game in years, so I don't really know if there's like a good template out there somewhere, you know? There certainly isn't. They're in this one to the bitter end. Sickening impact. I love how when you're holding a weapon, you just like shake it off, like a chair shot right to the head. This could cause a serious injury. Who's paying for all these weapons? These men are using so many weapons this match. That's oh my God! Meant to be used for. All right, back to the weapon. It sucks that these guys are both clean, so like they get nothing from those weapons. Maybe that was a factor to consider. If someone's defaultly dirty, or like we could just pick them as dirty, like in hardcore matches, so they get momentum. I don't know. Right with the reversal, by God.
I think we might be looking at the future.
Right,
of the
nice leg lock. We're already 6 minutes in. Look at how tight he's got it locked in. Yeah, this one's gonna take a while, but I have to commit to it. I need to know who the best NPC in 06 is. All right, this is the only way to find out. Okay. Wow.
All right, time to see what kind of toys we got under the ring.
All right, there's the 40th barbed wire 2x4. Take that barbed wire wrap 2x4 from him. I agree. Take it away from this psycho. You're just gonna stand there? You all right, man? This is such a goofy match. Maybe hardcore is not the play. There's only one thing that a 2x4 wrapped in barbed wire. We could try a backstage brawl as well, but that I don't know if that's gonna be much better. Simulating match in this game was never the best, to be honest. I think I've got a wow, riveting. This is just riveting gameplay here. Blow from the ring bell. All right, please. See, here's going to be the problem. Even if he gets him red, he's still got to do something to pin him, right? So, like, if the computer, like, just pins off a regular move, I guess that could be it. But otherwise, like, nobody's even gotten a finisher yet because I guess they're both clean here and they keep using weapons so they don't get, like, any momentum from it. And this game introduced, like, that dynamic momentum system rather than the classic one where it just charges up, which, to be honest, looking back, I think I kind of prefer the old style momentum system, like SVR and lower, you know? That's the way to do it. Grab a weapon from under the ring. All right. The 40th barbed wire 2x4 of the match. There you go, the baseball swing. That's a good animation. Let me tell you something. I felt that before. Oh God. All right, tap. He's tapping. Ring the bell. Just ring the bell. Screw him over. I don't care at this point. I hope there's not a time limit on that I didn't notice, because that would suck. He was one step ahead on that one. Please. I mean, the stamina management's been all right. We haven't seen anyone fall over. Just how much punishment oh my! Just pin him. Just pin him. Cover. He's gonna pin him off that. Really. Chimel's been busted open. Red gets the win. Red gets the win by getting some red on Chimel himself. All right, Red with a statement, all right? He's setting the bar for the tournament.
If you don't have what it takes, then you don't have what it takes.
I don't know if it's a matter of not having what it takes, Taz. Sometimes it's just not your night.
All right, Red gets the win. Very nice. So Red is moving on. You love to see it, to be honest. Yeah, so Red moves, man, moves on. So let's adjust here. So I think this is fine, to be honest. However, I think, what do I want to change? Do I want to actually change? No, I'm going to leave it in hard. I was thinking about changing it, but I think, I'm going to turn this up all the way up. I'm going to see how it is. I'm just going to see how it is. Because with that match, how slow, like nobody even got a finisher. So I want to see if somebody gets a finisher, it counts, to be honest. And those weapons will speed up stuff. That's maybe I'll turn it down, but for now I wanna see this. So okay, so the next match is Barroom Brawl Guy versus Earl Hebner. Okay, so this is going to be I wanna see the ladder match and see how the computer, like we already know the AI is terrible, but so I need to look at my key here, so since these guys are unlabeled and I didn't change the name. So Barroom Brawl Guy. I believe this should be him. Let's see. This should be Barroom Brawl Guy. I already forgot who's his opponent. Earl Hebner, alright. I also might start changing people to dirty in hardcore matches, but for now I'm just gonna leave it. Alright, ladder match. Here we go. You ready for the computer to grab the ladder every 5 seconds? Alright, ladder tips. Very nice. Hopefully you're reading this. Barroom Brawl Guy, are you reading this?
Right,
there we go.
Welcome from Portland, Maine. This is good old JR Jim Ross here with
Jerry. Here you go. Just like I said, the computer's obsessed with the ladders in this mode. Or this match type. Oh, God, Hebner! Hebner got so much momentum from that. That's a statement right there.
Back and forth.
There we go. And I hate this too. When you start climbing, they just keep swinging and they almost always knock them down in the first frame. It's so annoying. Look at this. Look at this. Somebody approved this for releasing the game. Hebner, you better put that finisher in the fridge, my man. Oh, night's over. Long animation. Say goodbye to that finisher, my man. Say goodbye. All right, Barroom Brawl Guy is here. Oh, he's not lined up, though. See, look, I hate this. They just start swinging. They almost always knock him off like that. All right.
I don't think I've ever felt more anticipation during a match.
I want to see someone break their... Look at that. Oh, my God. This game's AI is so funny. Oh, my God. That was insane. Yo, Hebner's crazy. Targeting the legs. There you go. Oh, my God. That was actually sick.
I think it's pretty obvious which way this one's going to go. He's going for the
title. All right, he's going for the replica title. Barroom Ball Guy, you better get up, my man. You have some drinks for the match? Get up! It's over! Hebner gets the win! Wow, that was a lot quicker. Oh my God. That was insane. They had at least one amazing spot though. That was crazy when they both jumped.
So much potential. I hate to see it.
Alright, I'm gonna need that title back so you can hang it back up for another match, Hebner. My God.
I think everyone lost in that one, including the WWE fans.
Barroom Brawl Guy was so disappointing, man. Now we don't get to see Barroom Brawl Guy versus Bartender now. The new replica WWE champion, Earl Hebner. Okay, so at least I guess we now know that ladder matches are in fact quick, so We don't have to... The game's just dead silent right now. What's going on? we don't have to do them all. We can just bust them out when we want to. This animation's longer than I remember. Right, I need that title back, my man. All right, there you go. Earl Hebner moving on. I gotta be honest, part of me just wants the people with unlabeled names to lose right away so it'll be easier to keep track of. That's that bias coming in, alright? Alright, Earl Hebner moving on to the next round. Next up, we got Backstage Brawl Guy 2 versus Eric Bischoff. Easy E in action. So, what kind of match is it gonna be here? Do we want to try something else out? Let's watch a barroom brawl. Let's see how that goes. Right, so it's Bischoff versus... Is it Barroom Brawl Guy 2? Or Backstage Guy 2, I mean? Yeah, Backstage Guy 2. So he's unlabeled, so I need to refer to my notepad I had written out for the stream. This should be Backstage Brawl Guy 2. Can they bleed? They are capable of bleeding, but they don't actually have blood texture. So you'll only see like blood on the map, but technically they are bleeding in the game. Though, interestingly, I guess since Bartender, I don't know if she's able to bleed or if she defaultly has... I don't know if she's defaultly assigned as male or female in the file, so I don't know. I guess... Well, I mean, I guess it wouldn't even let you select her if she's female in the game files, but... Alright, here we go. Hey, we get to see a Barroom Brawl Guy here. After losing his match, he's coming to play some pool, I guess. And there's Bartender. She's also in this tournament. Bischoff started off with a kick immediately. Alright, there you go. Use those environmental grapples. Easy E. Black belt. I'm cheering for Bischoff here, man. Dude, he's already got him yellow. Oh my god. He's already got him orange. This is, maybe turning up the environmental thing all the way up is a mistake. Alright, there you go. Bartender starting the competition. True. True. I love this game's bar brawl, though. It's so cool. It's like the spinner tables you can climb and like the basketball game animation. It's so good. There you go, Bischoff. Bye. He's already got him red. This is going to be over, man. Easy E with an easy victory. Low blow. It's all legal. Don't be yelling at him, ref. That's legal in this. He's going to pin him off that. The arrogance. No way.
1, 2, 3.
Easy E with an easy 1-minute victory. Backstage Brawl Guy 2 is garbage. Cue the Bischoff music. I guess that answers the question. He has his music assigned to his ID. Face facts, Backstage Guy 2. Your opinion doesn't matter, man. You're garbage. Easy E, moving on. Okay, so with that being said, should I turn down the environmental damage? Was that... Did I go overboard? Maybe just finish your damage all the way up, everything else default. Here's your updated bracket. Bischoff moves on to the next round. All right, let's turn. I think I'm gonna leave finisher. Okay, well, hold on. Let's Okay, no, I keep wanting to go to legend, but I'm not going to. I'm gonna leave. I think it's fine. Let's actually go like something like this. Let's try that. I mean, even though, like, I was saying, like, this stream's gonna take forever, I'm actually having a good time watching this, so I don't want it to end, like, immediately, but I also don't want to be here forever. Kind of want to record some stuff, you know, so. Okay, so moving on to the next round, it's gonna be Bartender versus, Red Moveset Man. Or do I want to go in reverse? Brian Hebner versus Michael Cole. Let's just do Bartender versus Red Moves now. Okay, well, do we want to try something else here? Man, a lot of these don't sound too intriguing with the AI, to be honest. If there was like actually people playing as somebody, that'd be great. Table match? That could be interesting, I suppose. Okay, this might be a big mistake, but I'm gonna try TLC and see how it goes. I know they still grab the weapons like crazy, but so what I say, Bartender versus Red. Okay, so they're unlabeled, so I gotta refer to my list here to find them. Okay, that's Bartender. She is dominating. I'm gonna put them both as dirty, so they actually get momentum from those weapons. Yeah, this should be Red. Judgment Day is here. Alright, Bartender making her debut after she was scouting out Eazy-E. Will she move on, or is Red gonna get another win? Or did the game just crash? No way it crashed. What? How? Alright, we're good. I guess you gotta turn off entrances for some people. Maybe she has a invalid entrance ID or something. I don't know. It's just all theoretical, but there we go. Bartender versus Red, right? WrestleMania 9 TLC match. Here we go. St. Louis, Missouri. Michael Cole, here with Taz at ringside. I'll tell you, table immediately. Alright, you know what? So fired up. I agree with it. I'm with you on that, partner. If she moves on, I'm definitely putting her in a barroom brawl. It has to be done. Going to town. Here we go. Big scoop slam finisher immediately. And here we go. Dirty grapple. Oh, oh, she can't lift him. That changes everything. He must be like a cruiserweight. He must be a heavyweight or something. I didn't even think about that. Wow, she's done. She's done. She's cooked. I think both her finishers pick him up, right? Dominator and... Or wait, what's your other finisher, though? Maybe it's not a pickup move. Seems like things have quieted down a little bit. Right, where's this goofball going? There's nothing up there, my man. The worst animation of all time. And he hit it. I can't believe it. If you ever ask me my least favorite move animation in any wrestling game, I might say that elbow drop, to be honest. I hate that move so much. It's so bad, dude. Nobody wants to lose. Oh, that is true. She could use a chair finisher if she gets in that situation. My God. Wow, he got a finisher from reversing that. We got double finishes on the board right now. Look, she's picking him up right here. There's no weight detection for that animation. That's a scam. She could steal his finisher or do a super dirty move, actually, because she's has dirty selected right now. If they're not buying tickets, we're not getting paychecks. Well, I don't think we'll have to worry about selling. She tried to grapple a standing opponent or a downed opponent. Why? Whoa! Atomic drop. Yeah, I agree. Those WWE Legend logos on the barricade is so stupid. I don't know why they did that. It's so dumb, man. Someone should make a mod where they remove that. Alright, she's got double finishers on the board right now. Are you gonna do something with those or just keep picking up stuff? Slipped out of that one. Oh, she should have went for the super dirty move. Probably should have thought that through a little better. Oh, she's done, dude. There's no way she's winning this tournament if she even moves on. If she moves on, maybe I should just give her ladder matches, but I want to give her barroom brawl matches, to be honest. But I guess it wouldn't make sense because she would be behind the counter and in the match. Twin magic. The worst animation of all time. Yo, I think Red's got this in the bag, though. These are trained WWE professionals. I mean, she should have experience kicking people out of the bar, right? There's probably some wild men there she had to throw out sometime. Double finishers right now. This is a rare sight. All right, please. Please, where are you going, ma'am? It's not easy maintaining. Oh, she actually hit that. After week, the superior elbow drop animation. Whoa. He's using that ladder like a battering ram. Oh my god. Maybe with the weapons, you might actually have a chance here.
Oh my god.
Oh, did I put red as clean? Oh, whoops. That's rough. Well, I guess that evens the odds. I didn't mean to do that. If I did, that sucks. All right, you need to do that super dirty move. Don't worry about the stamina. No, the computer's obsession with grabbing the ladder every 5 seconds. Oh, here we go. Here we go. Oh, she missed. Okay, we actually see a real ladder fight. This could change the complexity of the match completely.
Each of these competitors are going to.
I don't know who I'm rooting for. These are both two good NPCs, to be honest. Oh, oh my god, bartender. Hip toss on the top. Oh my god. That kind of landed on the table. But what are you doing, you psycho? You're not in the bar. You don't need to set up the tables anymore. What are you doing? The AI is so laughable in this game, man. Look, he put down the table, and then she grabbed it on, like, the first frame. Oh, neck. She reversed the finisher. She reversed the finisher. Right, where are you going, dude? There's nothing up there. We're outside. I don't have anything suspended up there. Oh, my God.
Looks like they might be taking this match down a notch here, Cole. How is a human body supposed to withstand that?
You know what I would love to see? Someone who's never played this game just react to this game's AI and just like give unfiltered opinions. Like, it would be so hilarious, dude. Big chair shot to the head, though.
Waste to his opponent with that steel chair.
You kind of got to wonder, though, if she wasn't, if she was actually able to pick him up. I wonder,
Man, look at these.
Oh my, you're a psycho. He actually hit that. I mean, if she was able to pick him up, I wonder how, if this would have been over already or not. Because she's tried that like, what, two or three times already?
For the greatest fans in all of sports entertainment.
What are my thoughts on Lacey Evans turning heel? To be honest, that kind of shocked me because I thought they were actually going to run with this babyface run with her, and like, I guess that's not the case, but to be honest, I think she's much better as a heel than a face. Or she's able to play a heel better than a face. And that's something I always think about, like, people that are much better at one side, like, either as AI or, what am I talking about, as face or heel, and then those rare people that can pull off both equally. That's something I always think about.
Man, I don't envy that ref. You know, the last
place. Wait, what are you doing, my man?
Superstars. You can say that again.
Stop. that actually blocking her with the ladder. All right, slow down with the sleeper hold. Surprisingly, with all these weapon shots, they're both only yellow, which is kind of shocking to me. I mean, we did turn down the weapon damage. Well, I guess technically it's turned up from default, but still. My God.
These are some of the greatest superstars in the world doing what they do best.
He set down the ladder twice and then went for the pin. What are you doing? Big kick out. Red is shocked.
And there's the reversal.
Alright, big reversal here. Are we actually gonna see some grapples or what? Irish. Oh, come on. No, okay. Damage is equal here, but I don't know if Bartender can pull this off with this cheese, man. Oh, she's hurt. She's hurt bad now. It's over. I think she's done, man. Okay, this psycho's going up top. He is clean, though, so it's actually a good idea. He missed. He missed. Actually, here's my question. With this man's red skin, is being outdoors like this good or bad for him? There you go. Are we going to see red busted open? No, we are not. Okay. Big drop kick from red. Oh, bartender's hurt, man. Bartender's hurt. You know, it's kind of funny. In like, back in the days of like the early days of hacking this game, people always referred to her as Bar Maid, but officially you gotta call her Bartender because that's what it says in the beta copy of the game. So it's Bartender, not Bar Maid. But I mean, I guess it doesn't really matter. Big reversal. All right, we're going back and forth here.
They sure are. Great.
Even if Bartender overcomes the odds, I think she's donezo with this weight class disadvantage here. Unless maybe if she's in the bar, home field advantage. Lutez press.
They sure have. And that's where the
do I think Natty's better as a face or a heel? I think heel, in my opinion.
No doubt, Cole.
I think it's like I don't even have to think about that one. I think she pulls off heel much better than face. I've seen matches won and lost simply because once that, like, when I say someone's better as either a face or heel, that's not saying they're terrible as the other alignment. I just think there isn't many people, in my opinion, that pull off both equally. I mean, like, just as good as a face and as a heel. My opinion, that's quite rare. Nothing left to give. Wow, great reversal. Great Paul Burchill. Yo, bartender's done, man. Big rush. Oh, it's over. Oh, she's out flat. Is he going to pin her? No, going for a weapon. Interesting choice. Not sure I agree with that, but of course, in this game, 06, people get up incredibly fast as well. He did not go for the finisher. Are you all right, my man? Is this red or blockhead red? These superstars are so unpredictable. Oh, I thought he was going for a table animation, but no. Oh, here we go. This maneuver. Maybe she's going to lose on purpose because she has to get back to the bar. She doesn't want to get fired by her boss, man. Snap Mary's got double finishers here. Bartender's momentum is reeling right now. She's screwed, man. Oh, tactical retreat. You know what? Good move. Going for the chair. I agree with this, man. I mean, Red's kind of a fan favorite, though. Oh, my God! She ran out of stamina during the swing. That looked so weird. Picking it right back up. Not even going for stamina. Interesting, man. Oh, neck break. It's over. He's not going for the pin. Are you serious? Is this man all right? Oh, is he gonna try to tap her out? Are submissions off in this? This has been going 10 minutes. Something's gotta give here. Got the headache now. Has anyone got any Tylenol in the crowd? Did Red suffer a concussion last match, or is this man alright? Wait, what are you doing? The worst devil of all time! Looks to me as this can go down in the books. It's funny because wasn't that move removed after this game and never came back? I don't recall that. Maybe I'm wrong, but I don't recall that being in the other games. So if that's the case, they probably recognize how dumb that move is. But I might be wrong. I don't really remember, like, fully, you know, because I haven't checked in a long time. All right, come on, please. Somebody just steal one here. Well, give him an A for effort. Yeah, and give him an F while you're at it, but no freaking way you can him. Oh, here, chair finisher? No, what are you doing? Oh, neck break. It's over. Just pin her. It's over. Send her back to the bar. There we cover. Bartender's done. Red moves on. Wow, Red with a pretty solid performance so far. Red gets the win. Send her back to the bar. That pinfall left no room for ambiguity. Nope. You let your shoulders stay down. You got to think, though, if she had a different weight class, I guess the randomized seed, man, didn't help her out. Red gets the win. I'm not talking about Red from 2K20 either. Hothead Red. That's the original Red right there. Alright, Red moves, man, gets the win. Give me a second to update my bracket here. Okay, so Red moves on. So next we got Jerry the King Lawler versus Vince McMahon. This one should be interesting because they both have actual movesets. Jerry Lawler, Vince McMahon. We take this backstage. We're gonna take this backstage. Let's go to the just the normal backstage. Well, actually, someone said they think Vince has an entrance, so maybe I shouldn't do this because there's no entrances backstage. I want to say he doesn't, but it's been a while since I've used these NPCs, so maybe I'm wrong. Nah, screw it, I'm not going to. Right, I guess Vince is going to be furious backstage here. Here we go, Vince McMahon, Jerry the King Lawler. Kurt Angle's watching over us here. Listen, Kurt, this is not the Just Bring It tournament, so you're not eligible, all right? Here we go. I love this backstage, too. Nice soda machine, very nice. Catering right there. Here we go. This is also where you'll see those backstage NPC guys. This is where they're from. They walk around back here and you can actually interact with them. All right, Vince is targeting the legs. Interesting choice here. Doing it in a suit as well. All right, you gotta use that environmental stuff, all right, my man. Use that electrical panel like they did to Gold Dust. There you go. Cool steam effects too, coming from the grates. My god, low blow. There you go, Vince. I wonder if they're actually going to do any environmental grapples here. They don't seem to care right now. Vince, another low blow. All right. I don't even know. I guess I'm cheering for King. Oh, he got the camera. Let's go. Oh my god. Vince is an orange head already. Oh my god. Is Vince going to be done here? Vince has had some controversy recently and it's piling on still. Honestly, people are saying Vince could be on his way out with all these allegations going on. Maybe they're not wrong. Got the camera though. Please, please do something other than Irish whip in the corner. Oh my god. There you go. Dirty punch. Lay him in. Yell at him all you want, ref. This is legal. Anything goes in the backstage brawl, alright? Kind of just wish I was playing this though, because there's a lot of cool animations in this this arena. Interactions and stuff. There you go. Come on, Ben. A lot of reversals here. This is crazy. Alright. Whip. Yeah, of course, when they finally whip, they whip him into the thing that has no interaction. Good. Standing swing to a down opponent. Standing swing to a down opponent. You gonna do it again, Vince? Standing swing to a down opponent. One more time, Vince. He's standing up, and he hit him. There you go. Like, you see those guys walking around. You can actually grapple them from interactions. One, it's really cool. Two, three. Oh, it's over. What? Vince gets the win. That was... What? Here's your winner. No chance for King. No chance, so that's what you got. Yeah. Vince isn't done yet, I suppose. Puppets. That was kind of a disappointing match, to be honest with you. It started off kind of strong, but then like that was the finish? Are you serious? Ow. Alright, Vince is moving on, but in the next round, he's going to have to face Red, who's been the MVP so far. So next up, it's going to be JR versus the Moveset Woman. So this should be an interesting match. I think it's time to bust out the ladder match again. So I need to pull up my list here. I need to see which one. Okay, Moose Woman is the very last unlabeled one. That's easy. Ram that arena. Judgment Day. I'm going to risk it and leave Entrance Design. I don't know if it's going to crash or not. No, all right, we're good. There we go. JR and Moose Woman. This is going to be a wild match. This could go either way. And of course, classic 06 AI. They both go for ladders immediately. Oh, she's going for the replica title already. She completely missed. Oh, here we go. Might see an actual ladder fight. Nope. You're a psycho. I don't care how many moves, animations you know, man. You can't be doing that. Oh, this should be interesting. And the ladders both fall over. That was so goofy. I don't think they'll be the same after this one. Oh my god. Oh, she didn't fall over from that. Soup bones! 15 feet in the air. Soup bones! Yeah, it still kind of blows my mind. Like, even when I first got this game, I noticed how bad the AI was. And I'm like, are you serious, man? I mean, it doesn't kill the game for me because this is probably still in my top five wrestling games, but it's like a major criticism for me, at least, the AI, the issues it has, man.
I gotta say, Cole, when I first heard about this match, I wasn't
right. I don't know who has the advantage here. I mean, Green Moves Woman, similar to Green Moves Man, knows every move animation in the game, all right? They got the experience, all right?
And I haven't been disappointed.
I mean, she's a psycho, though, with that elbow drop.
But I'll talk about getting stuck with you as a... I'll tell you what right now, Cole. There's not enough room up there for both of them.
Oh, actual ladder fight. Round two. Here we go. I kind of want JR to win, to be honest with you.
Jeez, what a... This is a pivotal moment. Whoever comes up short here...
Oh, no. Oh, God, JR. JR! Oh, I thought he was going out of the ring. You got lucky, man. Climbs up immediately.
Neither one of these superstars wants to fall off the ladder.
All right, whoever was the lead program for the AI of this game, step forward now. We gotta have a discussion. All right, you need to fix this, man.
Looks if he can win this struggle, he might just win the match.
Oh, dude, Green Muzumin laying him in right now. Who ordered the soup bones?
Man, I don't envy that ref. This is not a fight.
Oh, Jared's comeback. All right, another hip toss. How are none of these two, like, yellow yet? Oh my god, you're crazy. You're both crazy, all right?
Look at these superstars go.
Don't you dare jump. Oh, okay, I was going to say, she probably fell out of the ring. She would have jumped there.
These superstars, but
another ladder fight? This is ridiculous, man. You might have to go sparingly in the ladder matches because they're just so wild. And not really in a good way either.
Your opponent knocks you down from there, you might as well throw
another hip toss. My god, dude, still no damage. How? I mean, I know they both have low stats, but I kind of would be expecting yellow at this point, at least, right?
This is to build some momentum, and you're not gonna see a match one. It's a long fall for whoever loses this fight, Cole.
It's gonna be the long fall, 1 of 57 at this point.
So Cole, you got any predictions?
Come on, JR, bust up the barbecue sauce, all right? Another hip toss. Unless I see someone go out of the ring, I'm not impressed with those hip tosses anymore. We've seen them like 40 times.
Oh my god, they're tearing each other apart up there.
I mean, the most impressive thing about JR is his hat stays on the whole time. Got that super glue. Or maybe it's just barbecue sauce holding that thing on there.
Whoever loses this fight is going to have a long fall in their immediate future.
I should have put them both as dirty too, so maybe they get some momentum for weapon attacks. Still no damage. Wait, is there something weird going on here or what? Or does that hip toss really not do that much damage at all? I'm so confused right now. Or do those low strength stats really make that much of a difference? Like, I feel like we'd at least see yellow with all these hip tosses. I just wanted to hit that elbow so they at least get momentum. Alright, there you go. Slow it down, JR. Someone needs to generate a Meltzer rating after this match. It better not be anything higher than 2 stars. Let's be honest.
Hey, the ref's got a tough job. I mean, trying to keep these.
It's kind of funny. Like, someone thinking about now, like, let's say, like, wrestling wasn't, like, predetermined, like, matches. Like, let's say it was an actual competitive ladder match. I guess, theoretically, logically, you would want to climb the ladder right away to try to grab the thing right away, right?
These superstars are beating the hell out of each other.
Yeah, dude, honestly, that elbow drop kind of is hurting her because it jumps so far she keeps missing, and she's clean, so hitting that would actually help. There you go, finally.
Either way, Cole, it sure could. It's not over until the referee calls.
Oh my god, please. You're psychos, all right? This is so bad.
It's not easy, mate. Both of these
superstars. All right, if someone's not yellow after this, I'm calling shenanigans here. We may have to bust out the turbo button at some point. Another hip toss. There you go. His head's yellow, interestingly.
And I'm glad to see it. A WWE match.
Unless we get lucky and one of them fall out of the ring from that hip toss, like, I don't... This is going to go on for a while, it seems. This is so bad.
Only one of these superstars is...
Hey, look at that. Another hip toss, guys. Are you impressed or what? There we go. Yellow on the board here. Are we going to see our actual move? Are you kidding me? Oh, no. Irish whip into nothing. I was hyped for nothing.
I'm with you, partner. But it's got to end sooner or later.
Well, whichever way you go.
This is so stupid, man. Oh, my God.
Give it everything they got.
Wow, look at him up there. Trading shots back and forth.
Good Lord. People in the audience are clapping. Are you guys watching the same match I am or what?
No, what incredible intensity from these two superstars.
Yo, green woman laying in those rights, man. Is that the green woman's right?
This capacity, oh my God. Certainly getting its money's worth.
You know, this is kind of making me thinking, if I had to pick which wrestling game has the best AI, and what I mean by that is just from the standpoint of watching matches, which game do I think is the best? I don't even know if I have an answer. Maybe, does anyone in the chat have an opinion they can, like, pull off top of their head? Like, I'm trying to think of all the wrestling games, which one do I think has the best AI? Like, maybe you're gonna have to go with one of the 2K games, to be honest with you.
So have I.
But I don't know.
It's certainly been one of the most anticipated matchups in recent weeks.
Fire Pro, I agree. You just, as soon as you said that, I agree completely, yeah, because, like, there's so much depth to that, especially when you can customize people that have certain logic, so they'll actually play like the person you're creating, you know? Yeah, I agree. You just, thank you for that, because that's just, I agree completely with that. Speaking of which, it's been a long time since I've played Fire Pro Worlds. I did some videos a long time ago on it, actually. Some people actually don't like the Fire Pro game. GR's a psycho! Climb! Climb, Green, climb! I mean, he's got a finisher, though, so he might get up. Why are you trying to grapple a ladder? Are you alright? Oh, he's orange. That did a lot of damage. He's not getting up. He's got the replica belt. Okay, I was hyped. But what I was saying before is some people don't like Fire Pro because, like, they think it's too complex. And yes, there is a learning curve to the Fire Pro games when you first play it. You need to take the time to actually learn how it works, though. And it's worth it, trust me. Some people don't even give it the chance, and I would say you're making a mistake. If you never played any of those games, they're great, man. Especially even just watching matches is fun.
I think they're slowing that pace down a little bit.
But a lot of people just write it off completely. Oh, she's going for it. Interesting choice. Oh, we better not be stuck in a vortex of climbing and knocking him down. It's still not lined up.
These superstars are pounding the heck out of each other.
How many times did you miss that elbow drop? What? She knocked him down by setting up a ladder? That was crazy. Wow, she actually hit that. I'm shocked.
These superstars, Cole. I mean, they're not even contemplating the fact.
Oh my God, this is a nightmare. I feel like I don't want to do another ladder match. So far, backstage brawls have been the most reliable. By God. She's still only yellow after all this, though. And JR's not even gonna store that finisher, man. You alright, my man?
When's the last time you think they saw a match this good?
I couldn't tell you, Taz. I don't know if they've ever had anything this good.
Okay, if she can win this fight and JR's red after this, she might get the win here because he'll be down. I mean, if JR falls out of the ring, it's basically over, I think. Unless she's like, pulls a blockhead maneuver. Okay, here we go. Let's see. He's red. She might have a chance to win. He's flat. Climb. What are you doing? Okay, no, it's 06, so they no-sell. No-sell everything. Great.
Well, I think this one's pretty much a
this is a nightmare. I'm about to bust out the turbo button, to be honest with you.
You know, this wouldn't be the first time you've made a prediction that didn't pan out.
Fire Pro Wrestling D and Dreamcast is one of your favorite games. Dude, I like, you know which one I like too is Fire Pro Wrestling Returns. I still have my old mem card. So that game's on PS2. I still have my old mem card that had, like, I had, like, an insane roster on that.
Victory means absolutely.
Could bust it out one day. I mean, the roster's obviously way outdated by now because it was, like, I made that, or I didn't make that, I downloaded all that when it was new, but.
Or how about this one?
Yeah.
The superstar who beats their opponent will be the winner.
How about...
You know, I kind of wonder if anyone, like, when they were developing this game, if they ever watched the ladder match and said, you know what? This is not good. We should fix this.
I think this proves without a doubt why SmackDown's the dominant brand in sports entertainment.
I can't help
Hey, guys, another hip... Can I get a hip toss counter at this point?
Yeah, and even if you did, you'd have to listen to a couple of yahoos jabbering about puppies and...
What's my favorite wrestling arcade game? So, interestingly, it's actually WrestleMania the arcade game. I love that. I want to do a playthrough of that, but my playthrough would be where I actually, like, I feel like... No disrespect to anyone else, but I feel like some of the playthroughs I've seen, people don't utilize the combos. There's some really good combos in that game. And if you play it and don't have knowledge of how to pull off the combos, you're probably not going to like it. But once you learn how the combos work and memorize them, it's a lot of fun. Also, a really good behind-the-scenes video of Bret Hart in that game. If you've never seen it, look it up. It's really cool. And funny enough, I have a PS1 copy of that game. I got signed by Bret when I met him. If I did the playthrough, though, I would use the actual arcade version instead of the PS1 version. Which I don't think there's really that many differences, but it would just be cool to have the arcade experience, you know. Another hip toss! And he canceled that into the tired animation. That was weird. We do a table match? Oh, God. I don't know. I really don't remember the table AI. Like, I know they grab the table every 5 seconds, but do I don't know. Has anyone simulated a table match recently in this game? Is it bad? So far, I'm like in Backstage Brawl, to be honest with you.
I hope this isn't the last time we see these superstars face off. You're not gonna hear
them. Okay, if Green can throw him out of the ring with this, is this gonna go out of the ring? Climb, please, for God's sakes, climb. What are you doing? Why does it matter? You're taunting! Are you serious? Do you have brain damage?
It's a family show. I said exasperate.
Oh, he's still down. Maybe.
He's literally inches
away. Oh my God, that was such a blockhead move. Are you serious? That was opportunity knocking, and you decided to taunt? Now you're out. JR deserves the win after that. She's out. Oh no, she's up because 06. You guys, right as someone said Green Giant in the chat, I was about to ask, does anyone think Green actually, like a Green and Green Female just eat vegetables, that's all they eat? Like broccoli and stuff like that. Spinach, asparagus.
This could be the match right here, can he do it?
Oh my God, please, this is a nightmare. I'm actually in a nightmare. Okay, unless the AI is really, oh. No, okay. Sometimes the computer can get blocked by a ladder and they fail to grab them, so.
Oh, come on, Cole. You know, you should let me train you.
I feel like this isn't going to end unless we get someone out of the ring again, but Green was so dumb. She taunted. I don't understand why.
You make Marine drill instructors look like pushovers.
Like, the computer's always, like, hyper-focused on climbing the ladder, and when they finally have a real opportunity, she decides to taunt. That blew my mind. Another hip toss. What are you doing? Can we get the title's not over there, ma'am. Can we get the medical team to check on Green? I think she has a concussion or something. Big elbow, though.
Let me tell you, Cole. I spoke to these superstars before the match.
Okay, this is interesting. This is the worst match of the stream, no doubt about it. Is this the real Green moveset woman, or is this an imposter, man?
He's almost got it.
Okay, this is probably not gonna work. Oh, JR, he's blocked for the ladder, is what I'm talking about. They start. It's over. Green moveset woman gets the win. Oh my God, in the worst match of the tournament thus far. Oh my God. I'm just glad it's over, man. Let's not do a ladder match again, to be honest. Green moveset woman gets the win. I guess experience pays. Meltzer rates it negative 2.25 stars. And you know what? That's fair. That's fair. Holder of the replica title. Green moveset woman. Oh my God. Jesus, dude. You know, as soon as her and Vince walk backstage, her and JR walk backstage, Vince is going to be furious and yelling, "What the hell was that? You jumped off the ladder 50 times, pal." God, that was terrible. Jesus, dude. If anyone in the future is watching on YouTube, hopefully you skipped through that match, because that was terrible. But if you're on the live stream with me right now experiencing this, you were stuck with this nonsense. You had to suffer with me, all right? Oh my god. Jesus, I don't think I'm doing a ladder match again, man. It's such a gamble. That first one ended quick, but that took, what was that, like 15 minutes or something? Okay, here's your current updated bracket. So up next we got Backstage Guy 1 versus Green Moves Man. So we could potentially see Green Moves Man versus Green Moves Woman if Green Moves Man wins. Does the AI exit the Hell in a Cell in this game? Do we want to find out? Or we could do a Hell in a Cell next. We're gonna do it. We're gonna find out. This might be a risk. Okay, so Backstage Guy 1, I believe, is the first unlabeled one, but let me verify on my list. Yeah, this is him. Schoolgirl outfit, of course. And then Green Moves Man. So he's after the Bartender. All right, time to get extreme. ECW one night stands. This is Hell in a Cell, ladies and gentlemen. I kind of want Green Moves Man to win so we can see the Moves Man or Moves People match, I guess. All right, here we go. Backstage Guy 1, Green Moveset Man, Hell in a Cell. I've never seen a crowd so fired up. Let's be honest, whatever happens in this match, it can't be as bad as that last match, right? Well, you never know, but hopefully not. Standing grapple to a down opponent, good start. Alright, here you go.
So who do you think's gonna win this match, JR?
Oh yeah, they're both unlabeled, so let's see. Let's look at somebody doing a move and see who flashes. Okay, so Green's on the right, because he's defending in a submission right now. The submission is locked in. And I will probably forget this information within 3 minutes. There you go. Slow it down with an arm lock. We've already seen more moves than that ladder match, I think, at this point. I mean, part of me also consider for this tournament, just making everyone 100 overall, so they're all even, but I kind of like the idea in my NPC tournaments of leaving them as they're originally intended or appear in the game files. So whatever they have is whatever I use, you know. Unless it's something that crashes the game or it's an aesthetic change, like height or something, you know. There you go. Big back suplex. Very nice. It's kind of funny because isn't Green Moves Man going to be in the AEW game? Because I remember when they showed, I think it was the Darby Allin preview video, he was fighting Green. So does that mean Green betrayed us? Or not us, WWE? Did he betray WWE? Because in 2K22, it's not Green Moves Man. It's just regular dude. Generic bald guy. Does that mean Green signed with AEW? Green is all elite or what? Confirmed?
You got that right, JR. You're not going to see this kind of action on SmackDown. Not on SmackDown or anywhere.
All right, come on. I'm cheering for Green here. Backstage Guy, I don't care about this, man. All he does is walk backstage, man.
Of seeing the Raw superstars perform live.
There you go. Let's see some actual grapples. There you go. Oh, no, I think he reversed it. My God. I gotta say, I'm really looking, I'm looking forward to the AEW game. A lot of people are saying already it's gonna suck, but we haven't seen that much to say. Like, I know people are making fun of the graphics, which I guess, when you compare, like, to 2K22, like, obviously, it doesn't look nearly as good as that. But to me, gameplay is the most important thing, so. And, you know, I love Yuke, so I'm optimistic it's gonna be good. Plus, anytime we see more console wrestling games, I'm happy with that, regardless of who it is.
I'm not so sure there are issues with each other. Watch out! He reversed it!
They're anxious about the AEW game. Yeah, I guess people are gonna have expectations, like, you know, and plus it's gonna be the first console AEW game, so like maybe people's expectations are gonna be too high, you know. I don't know. You can't take this kind of pain for long.
These fans can't stand it when he does this, JR.
There you go. Ref yelling at him. This is Hell in a Cell. Anything goes, my man. You can't be yelling at him. For that move, but I don't think that bothers him too much, quite frankly. Who do I think will be slot one? I don't know. That's a good question, because it's funny because in the WWE games, a lot of people have their slots. Well, not everybody, but there's some people that always have their slot reserved. So obviously, since it's AEW now, probably the slots are going to be all different. So that's a good question. I don't know. Does anyone have any guesses? You're saying Kenny Omega? That's probably a good guess. That's probably a really fair guess, because he's actually involved with, I was going to say developing, but it's advising, I would say, and like giving direction on the game, so.
Oh man, I've been in this hole before, JR. This brings back some bad memories.
I can understand why, King. I can't even imagine.
Oh, we're seeing a possum pin in the tournament. He's only yellow. That's probably not going to work. It's kind of a blockhead move, though. Oh, big kick out from Backstage Brawl Guy, or Staff, or whatever you want to call him.
And it's been reversed.
Big reversal. Okay, that was so disappointing. I thought we were going to see a cage animation. You just threw him in.
This is a classic matchup, King. I'm so glad the WWE fans are...
Yeah, story mode is also on top of my list of things I want to see. If I had to pick some other things off the top of my head for the AEW game, I think one crucial thing is a pretty good creator wrestler system, because I really do think... that's one of the most important things in a wrestling game. I know some people don't care about that, but the idea to me is when you have a good creation suite, it's the idea of the community basically creating content for your game to give it more longevity, right? So it's like, oh, I can download some wrestlers, because wrestling is an ever-changing thing, which is why it's good to have community creation type things, so the community can update stuff for you. I know mods is another option for that, so depending on if it's mod friendly or not, we'll answer that question. Plus, you typically can't use mods on most console games, so
these superstars are so...
I think creation suite's really good. Neck breaker, it got reversed. Or 30
minutes. I hope it's the latter, King. It wouldn't hurt my feelings one bit if this match lasted the rest of the night.
Please don't say that, JR. I don't want this match to last the rest of the night.
I don't think these superstars have any intention of taking it easy on each other.
Big headbutt from Staff Guy too. Or is this one? I forgot already. I was really considering changing their HUD names to be labeled, but I advised against it because it'd be changing, but it's kind of hypocritical of me, because I said I'd do aesthetic changes, but I decided not to for some reason. And without them, we'd all be out of a job. What a counter! I mean, Green Moves Man's running away with this, though. Backstage Brawl Guy is terrible. I should call him Staff. It's Staff 1 and 2.
You can look at any professional sport you want, JR, and you won't find more incredible athletes than the WWE. There's the pin! One, two,
Northern Lights? Oh, big kick. I thought that was going to be it. He's got him right off that.
Excellent counter. What ring presence?
Okay, ribs coming into play. Bring back Creator Wrestler formulas. It's kind of funny, like a while back I was at my dad's house, like grabbing some stuff, and I opened a drawer and there was a printout from like 2005 or 6, like a call formula for Raven for, I think it was SVR06. I'm like, oh my god, this is still in this drawer. That's hilarious, dude. Just brought back memories of printing out Creator Wrestler formulas, because sometimes like my console was not in the same room as the computer, so like I had to print it out and then bring it over to another room. Neck breaker, it's over. This is a strong performance. Pin him. What are you doing, my man? Oh my god. That should have been it, man. Big drop kick, very nice. Yeah, Red is really, he's really going to the business for himself here, man. That was the finish, man. So far, I think Backstage Brawl is the most reliable quick match if we need it. We've seen many superstars tap out to this very hole. Headbutt to the back of the green head.
You're not going to get him with that one.
Oh, going for the neckbreaker on Green. That's his finisher, man.
Who wins this one?
It's kind of funny because Green knows every move ever, and he chooses to have a neckbreaker as his finisher. It's like, are you serious, man? Out of all the moves in the game? Yeah, you're going to use that finisher or just stand there? Oh, he's got the finisher glitch, actually, because that's a fake store finisher. I didn't even notice that till now. What? That's it. That's the finish. Okay. I wasn't expecting a strike. It was like just a drop kick for the win. All right. Cool. Cool, dude.
He might have gotten the pinfall.
All right, so we're seeing Green Moves Man and Green Moves Woman in the next round. They definitely have to have a regular match, not just like a backstage brawl.
I'll tell you what, JR. Getting the win takes a lot of the edge off of the pain.
Computer didn't even go outside the cell. They went like to the ringside area, but they didn't even do a throw into the cage animation, man. That was disappointing. Green Moves Man wins in pretty convincing fashion. I don't even think he had any body damage. Good lord, that's a statement right there. Crowd's completely silent. I don't know how to react to that. There you go. Kind of glad he won, to be honest. Is the green model based on someone in particular? In this game, I can't remember, but in 07, I believe it's actually just a modified Kurt Angle that's red. And Green Moves Woman's a modified Trish Stratus that's green. I know in 07, if you extract the face texture, it's literally just Kurt and Trish just greened out. And the models are just slightly modified based off them. In this game, I can't remember if that's actually Kurt or not. I don't recall. Okay, Green Moves Man gets the win. Just give me a second, my tournament bracket is taking forever to update. I love this website, but sometimes it hangs a bit. There we go. Okay, here's your updated bracket here. So it looks like up next we got Lilian Garcia versus Earl Hebner. I think we gotta take this one backstage. Oh my god. I think this is the parking lot. Alright, Earl Hebner 64 overall with Lilian. Wait, where is Lilian Garcia? Oh my god, did I not unlock Lilian? How am I just now noticing this? Oh my, alright. Intermission time, I gotta unlock Lilian Garcia real quick. What? I didn't even notice this entire time. Did I read off her name at the beginning of the stream? I know why, I know the answer. I don't think you can use women in the backstage brawl. Hold on, let's see. Yeah, that's why women aren't able to be in the backstage brawl without hacking. So never mind, that's not gonna be a backstage brawl. So, oh, what do I do now? There's pretty much, in this game, the females can barely compete in most matches. So I guess just gonna be a single match. Oh god, this one might take a while. Oh goodness. Do a ladder match? Dude, I'm traumatized from ladder simulation this game. I think I'm gonna avoid the ladders. Alright, Lilian Garcia, Earl Hebner on SmackDown. I left entrances on, so hopefully the game does not soft lock. Alright, we're good. I don't know why it softlocked at one time, because I know even if they don't have an entrance, it just doesn't play. It doesn't crash the game. Alright. Did he just shoulder block the ref immediately? Oh no, and Hebner has the moveset where he yells at people. This might be a nightmare. Big slap! Big slap!
Nothing that I can think of, Taz.
I know this. Oh, hopefully this isn't the game where you can't pin the referee. Some of the games are like that where you just can't pin them. All right, get out. He's telling her to get out. So if this is going to be an issue, I'm going to change Lillian's gender to male. Stop yelling at her, please. Pick up the pace a little bit. What are you talking about? This might be a big slap. Old school wrestling here. Oh my, this is really, I might just quit and change her to male real quick. If I even remember how to do that off the top of my head.
And there's the reversal.
Can women compete in ladder matches in this game? Because I don't know, ladder matches are so risky though, watching in this game. About Hawks is they gotta pump some blood to the brain.
Oh, I'm trying to think of a solution here. Unless Lillian just goes into overdrive mode and deals some damage here. Superplex! From these superstars, but this is even better than I'd hoped. Earl's unpinnable, so it is confirmed. What do I do then? I need a solution here. I could change Lillian to male, but I don't. I'm gonna have to remember how to do that. In this ring tonight. Won't surprise me one bit, Cole. This is a great match, and I have memorized how to enable them. I don't have memorized the gender. If the WWE fans aren't happy, they'll let you know it. Great reversal. Great Paul Burchill.
Dude, buried alive. Can women compete in buried alive? I'm gonna quit this because this is a nightmare. Can women actually compete in buried alive? I'm putting on turbo, by the way. Nope. Okay, we have a problem here. I might have to do ladder, dude. I hate watching ladder matches, but wow, they can't even compete in the ladder matches. This is a scam. All right, intermission. Hold on. Yeah, it worked. I'm in business here. Look at ladder. I can use any of the divas now. Alright, that didn't take as long as I thought it would. Okay, so now with that being said, what do we do? Ladder match? If you can't pin Hebner, I think ladder might be the only option. Or table, I guess, right? Okay, do we actually want to watch Buried Alive? Alright, we'll do it. Alright. Will I regret this? Find out next. I almost like the Triple H. Lilian Garcia versus Triple H. Remember that one time she introduced him as the former world champion? He like chased her down. All right, Lilian Garcia, Earl Hebner, take two. John Cena looks on. He's watching over us, man. Okay, here we go. Let's see how bad the AI. It's been a long time since I've watched an AI buried alive match, so let's see. Gentlemen, welcome to a sold out show here in Green Bay. Big snap jab. Shoulder block statement right there. Man, gender restriction is gone, man. There's a whole lot of cheese heads in the house tonight. It sure is. I mean, to be honest, the gender restrictions I always thought were stupid, with the exception of First Blood, I can get that, but everything else, like, why? You know, like, it's even bad or worse than the newer games where, like, mixed tag, you just slightly touch the woman as the guy and it's over.
Man, even if you end up winning a match like this, you're gonna be feeling for the next week.
The next week? Yeah, yell at her, yell at her. He's saying, get in the casket. Get in the casket. As well as physical. Get in the casket. Is that much worse? Emotional?
The hell are you talking about? Could we have made a Fulfill Your Fantasy match instead?
Do you think the bypass gender applies the males to the Fulfill Your Fantasy? I've never tried that. I doubt it, but I'm kind of curious now. It's not a pretty sight. All right, just keep yelling at her. Good strategy. This one's gonna keep on going. I mean, is Hebner even gonna win? Like, he's just gonna keep yelling at her, right? That could be quite a while from now. Oh God. This is never ever. This is a nightmare because she can't pick him up and he just keeps yelling at her. We might have to do ladder, man. We might be stuck in a vortex here. Don't try to pick him up. Stop. What are you doing?
I don't think they'll be the same after this one.
Just grappling him and doing nothing. What's happening here? Stop! Oh, I think we have to. If this, I'm gonna give it like. I think we're in a vortex.
No question about that, Taz. You won't last long against an opponent you haven't done your.
Don't the women have specific models for fulfill your fantasy? Yes. So, even if they did, the other people did show up on that menu, the game would crash because they would be trying to load a model number that doesn't exist.
I got no idea what these superstars are gonna do next.
That makes two of us.
Okay, this I'm done. We're going to ladder. I'm sorry. I hate ladder, but I don't see any other option here. I don't know what else to do. Oh my god. Not last man standing. Good god. I'm putting in both as dirty too, so they get momentum from the ladder. Copy someone else's moveset to Earl. So that is a solution. However, I gotta stick with my the game soft locked again. I gotta restart again. I honestly want Lillian to win, so we don't have to deal with Earl yelling at people. But Brian Hebner's in this too, so that's gonna be a nightmare. I don't know who he's facing off the top of my head, but alright, here we go. Is this take three now? Oh my god, another ladder nightmare, please. Please, God. Here we go. There we go, nothing new here.
It's been a long time since we've come to Portland, and it's great to be back.
No doubt, no doubt, Cole.
Please just grab it right now and win. No, it was too good to be true.
I can't wait, and neither can these fans. We better get started, or we might have a riot on our hands.
Oh my god, that happened. All right, here we go. You ready for another hip toss? I'm not gonna lie, it's kind of tempting to put on the turbo button. Hip toss!
It's not easy maintaining this type of intensity week after week after week, Cole. Trust me.
I don't doubt it, Taz. The WWE superstar. This is a.
Shouldn't I made him face to the diving moves do mega damage? Yeah, I guess either way it would work. Well, actually, maybe you're right because they don't seem to be swinging the ladders nearly at all. They just keep climbing them, so maybe yeah, face is or clean is the better option.
These superstars are.
It's too late now. I don't want to take four, so I'm just going to deal with it. Oh, she throws him out of the ring here, though. Come on. No! I'm trapped in a nightmare.
A little bit here, Cole.
I think this may just be the calm before the title is only inches away.
Okay. Wait, she's not even grabbing onto him there. Okay, Earl's already yellow. Maybe this isn't going to be as bad as I thought.
Conditioning is a huge factor in any match.
It's a huge factor.
There ain't no way you're gonna come on.
Oh, he's down. Is this gonna be it? Hebner's not getting up. Throw up the X. He's hurt. Lillian Garcia gets the win. Get Earl out of here. Let's go. No more yelling. He's done. Wow, that was the duality of the ladder match. It's a gamble. We're either getting a 15-minute annoyance or a 2-minute convenience.
Wait, that's it? No.
Nah. No, that's good. I'm glad that's it. You better not be complaining, Taz.
Rules are rules. Yeah, but this isn't right, Cole. I mean, come on, you gotta admit, this is a total letdown for everyone, including these superstars.
It's not a letdown for me. This is exactly what I wanted. The new replica WWE champion, Lillian Garcia. Oh my god. Thank god. The duality and risk of the ladder match. Meltzer gets at -3 stars. You know what? Fair. Someone has a match of the year sign in the crowd. Were you watching the same thing as me? Are you alright? Get your eyes checked, man. Oh, she's facing Taz and she's done. She's done. She's facing Taz. She's absolutely done. Good lord. That was quite the roller coaster from having to remove the gender restriction to having to start the match 4 times. All right, my bracket's taking forever to update though.
Yo, I rock the South Bay to LA from
Alright, so here is your updated bracket. So we got Taz versus the coach up next. So with this cheat, I can make Trish the WWE champ? I don't know, let's see. I don't know if it means gender restriction in the sense of titles as well, or just matches. Yeah, it works. Wow. it removes the restriction on the titles as well. That's crazy. Here's the real question. Can I make Triple H the women's champion? No, this cheat code's a scam. It only works towards the women. This is ridiculous. I'm pissed. Well, I guess actually if you change Triple H's gender to female with this cheat, then you would have no restrictions. Alright, whatever. Okay, so what I say it was? It was Taz versus the coach. You know what? Let's go back to a single match here. WrestleMania 9, we're back. Alright, remember Taz was my pick to win the tournament, so so we're soft locked again. Great. Oh my god. Alright, here we go. I believe Taz is the highest overall NPC, which honestly was my reason for picking him. Got his actual moveset too, so ready to see some Taz missions, ladies and gentlemen. Here we go. Taz, no pressure, but if you win this tournament, I correctly guessed all three winners from the stream. That would be insane. So please get the job done. And normally I make fun of Taz for wrestling in sunglasses, but we're in an outdoor arena. This is practical in this situation. There we go. I want to see some capture suplexes. A belly to belly Taz plex. I want to see it all. All right. An high angle backdrop from from the coach.
These superstars are so
come on, Taz.
I'm having a hard time figuring out what they're going to do next.
Don't bother, Cole. I don't think you're going to be able to. Just sit back.
It's kind of funny how Taz is still 85 overall when, like, at this point, he was a commentator for a decent amount of time. Well, coach has got a finisher for Taz. Are you kidding me?
He reversed it.
Is it because he hit the ref and got some dirty momentum there or what? Oh, no. I don't even know what coach's finisher is. He stored it. Oh, God.
It's crazy to think we actually get paid to do a job like this. There's thousands of people.
Taz is yellow. I'm scared. There's no way coach is pulling this off.
Maybe I should look into that.
Stop! I could get a better broadcast part. Come on, Taz. You have a good submission stat.
Hurts even worse than it looks.
Oh, yeah. The finisher that boosted damage. Oh, no. You can't. It can't end like this for Taz. Yo, coach is going crazy. German to Taz. No way. Oh, God. Oh, no.
Man, I'll tell you what, man. This one's just...
I mean, this Taz had a disadvantage because he has to commentate and wrestle at the same time. Dude, coach is insane.
There
we go. German Taz flex. Lay him in.
That don't happen too often.
That's an understatement.
There we go, triangle hold. He's tapping, I see it, he's tapping. No, he got out immediately, wow.
Look at how tight he's got it locked in. Look at this.
Oh, it's a step up into Guri's finisher.
And that's a heck of a finisher right there.
He just stares at him. What are you doing? Okay.
He anticipated that move perfectly.
One thing I'm concerned about with Taz is a disadvantage. Both finishers are Taz missions, so if they're in a match where give up is off,
so Cole,
if he doesn't go for the pin right away, then it's a waste, you know.
No way.
Pin off a submission, geez.
You embarrass yourself with enough bad guesses that I'm not going to risk doing the same.
Two.
Into the steps. All right, coach is surprising me.
Three.
Now he's just walking. What are you doing, my man? You all right?
How much can these superstars possibly have left?
They got as much left as it takes, Cole. Trust me. You get in that ring and you find out you got reserves you never knew you had.
I can imagine. Nothing pushes you to the limit quite like a WWE.
I'm also looking
match.
Forward to Cole's match with whoever he's facing. Maybe I should have dropped the link to the tournament bracket in the chat so you can check it without me having to pull it up on the screen. You know? Airplane spin from Taz? Okay. You can follow up with this move. Let's see what he does. Behind grab. Oh, there we go. Head arm Taz flex. Here we go. He's cooking now. He's cooking. Keep on the attack, my man. What are you doing? Snap jab, all right. Go for a clean grapple. Another one? Oh no, Samoan drop. All right.
A WWE match isn't just about competition. It's also about,
you know, honestly, if I have to be honest though, the NPC tournaments of the older games are a lot more fun because the stats aren't necessarily, there isn't that big of a gap in the stats, and it's a lot more fast paced. I think the 2K22 Tazz mission, Tazz mission. Oh my god, I think the 2K22 tournament's gonna be fun, but it's also gonna be a lot of work to set that up. He got out, wow, that's a scam right there. And he got up immediately. Complete scam. Tazz mission, Tazz mission.
I mean, they're not even contemplating the fact that they might lose here tonight.
They sacrificed so much to get here, Tazz. I don't think they can allow that thought to enter their heads.
All right, come on, Tazz, you're orange. You're my pick, my man. You can't be doing this.
It's obvious these superstars have studied each other real carefully, Cole.
Yeah, here we go. Another Samoan. Oh, here we go.
You won't last
cooking
long against an opponent you haven't done your homework on.
He likes fighting dirty.
Oh, low blow, okay.
He's pretty good at
you know what?
He certainly is.
It's all good.
And I hope he's proud of him.
You proud of that, Tazz?
I find it disgusting.
Unbelievable. Dude, I'm shocked that Coach is keeping up this well. He's like, what, like 50-something overall? And like, Tazz is 85? I'm honestly shocked. What are you doing, Tazz? You all right? He went behind, went for a body punch that completely whiffed.
It's not easy maintaining this.
Another Samoan drop.
Week after week, Cole. Trust me.
He saw that one coming.
Oh my god. If one of these matches actually ends in DQ, that'd be hilarious. That does actually happen a decent amount. If you watch my playthrough, that happened to me and it was annoying a couple of times. Because the ref likes to just get in your grill in this game, my man. Like, trying to grill some burgers here and he's just right up in there. Right on the grill. He's got his face in the charcoal, basically. That's how much in your grill he is. And like, you accidentally hit him so much. It's annoying.
Your guess is as good as mine, Tazz.
Right, how many Samoan drops?
Easy on each other, that's for sure.
Are these men gonna do? Ross face! If he beats Tazz by submission, I'm jumping out my window. You can't do that.
Right,
that's not allowed.
Surprise me one bit. The longer you stay in this, the more risk you have for serious injury.
Okay, Coach's stamina management's not been good. That's a big mistake right there.
Nice reversal.
Nice, Paul Burchill. Man, speaking of Paul Burchill, whenever I do my 07 playthrough, I wish you could play as Burchill in season, but you can't because he doesn't have any voiceovers. It's the biggest scam of all time. We got screwed with that. I will never forget that, all right? That's a complete scam. I could probably hack the game to force his superstar ID to be the main character, but if I wouldn't have voiceovers, I wouldn't want to do that for the main playthrough, you know?
Athletes compete here tonight. I had a feeling they were going to wind up against each other sooner or later.
Can I play as Brock Lesnar? Brock Lesnar was actually removed from this game. His slot still exists, but there's no model. Apparently, from what I'm hearing... Oh, here we go! Oh my god. Apparently, like, someone has his model, but none of that stuff's publicly available. The only publicly available, like, removed models right now are, like, some variants of people already in the game and Maven and Luther Reigns, so...
I'm getting exhausted just watching them.
If someone actually releases that Brock, like a beta version that has Brock still intact, that would be great. Because that one beta version that got posted online, Brock was already removed at that point, unfortunately. Honestly, we got lucky that Luther Reigns and Maven weren't removed in that. We got lucky because I think we cross-referenced the dates and like Maven was already released at the time of that build coming up. He was disabled but not removed.
I'm just saying that in a great match like this, everyone involved...
How would someone get that model? Did they work for the company? I don't know. Apparently, I'm talking about, like, Scott J, I think, has it. I think he has contacts within, like, the industry of people that have these beta copies. And he like, either buys them off them or something. I don't know. I'm not really too sure, to be honest. He's probably answered that in one of his videos. But... Oh, Northern Lights? Tazz Flex? Is it over? It's over! Tazz gets the win!
He might have gotten the big winner.
All right, Tazz moving on. I was a little scared, but he came through. All right, very nice.
I'm with you, partner, and I think these fans are too.
Well, I hope so, Cole, because when the fans speak, the WWE...
I mean, if we get lucky and like another huge lot of PS2 games gets posted again, we get lucky and there's an even earlier build, I mean, we might be in business. Because apparently, Jackie Gata and Kenzo Suzuki have models too that hopefully will get released. Tazz moving on to face Lilian Garcia in the next round. Looking good for Tazz right now, I must say. Alright, so moving on is Tazz. Next round we got Teddy Long versus Eric Bischoff. This should be fun. Yeah, that is true also. Mr. America was going to be in this game. His call name is still within the retail disc. And actually, I utilized his slot for one of these alternate attire guys for this video. And remember, Mr. America is not Hulk Hogan. That's a lie, alright? Buried alive, alright. Screw it. Eric Bischoff, Teddy Long. Battle of the GMs. Yeah, that's also true. Ezekiel is not Elias. They were, like, people saying Ezekiel is Elias, you're completely wrong. There was clearly video footage of them both talking to each other. There's no way to argue against that. They're not the same guy. So the people saying that, like Kevin Owens, you're just wrong. Plain and simple. I just get all zeked up thinking about that, you know? Oh, hard Irish rip to open the match? That's what I like to see. Just go right up to that casket immediately. That's what I want to see right now. Don't you dare get back in the ring. Go up the ramp. Let's see it. There we go. All right. We're in business right now. These guys know what they're doing. A lot of reversals here. Look at this reversal fest. All right. Gonna put out a 5-star classic? I can respect it. Oh my god. That was a crazy sequence, actually. And usually when you have that kind of hype, Bischoff's about to run over Teddy. Imagine there was an Easter egg where you could call for interference in a match against Teddy and a car just comes down the ramp and runs him over. One of the best cutscenes of all time in a WWE game. It's so funny, dude. Just the way he sells getting hit, like does like a corkscrew, it's hilarious, man. But a lot of people don't realize what they sacrificed behind the scenes. This match is already 10 times better than that one ladder match that we watched. You've got to sacrifice just about everything for your career. It has to be as important to you. I gotta be honest, I'm rooting for Eazy-E here, to be honest. I think Bischoff might be my all-time favorite GM, to be honest with you. I think he excelled in the role. That's why you see so much passion for what. All right, here we go. They're on the mound. And that's something you won't see anywhere else. Watch out them karate kicks, my man. Respect to every athlete and entertainer out there. No one gives as much of themselves to their fans. Do you think we're going to see a casket finisher? I doubt it, but it's possible. You need two finishers to pull that off. He saw that one coming. Oh, Bischoff with the kicks.
Look at it. You feel like a real jerk when somebody counters you like that.
Oh my god, they're just going back. This is a good match, dude. Back and forth.
Man, look at these superstars. You can't.
Surprised no one's going for that shovel, man. What makes SmackDown so great? That Triple H brand shovel. SmackDown's got the greatest superstars. Russian leg sweep. Greatest matches for the greatest fans in all of sports entertainment. Oh, kick him off the mound? Oh no, he's floating. Oh, he's going for. There we go. Here we go. We're in business now. We've seen an excellent. Oh, Teddy's backing away. He's scared. Oh, he's choking him. My god. My god. Someone's got to stop this. Don't start getting squeamish on me, Cole. Inflicting pain is the name of the game. Name of the game, brother. Yo, Bischoff's going wild right now. Oh, my god. Okay. You know, the key to, we still haven't seen an attempt to put anyone in the cat. Oh, maybe until now. Oh, no. The shovel blocked it. One with just one or two moves. No, but one shovel coming into play. The tactical shovel placement, all right? Valid strategy. Completely. And there's the counter, Cole. I gotta say, when Buried Alive, when I first played this as a kid, I was hyped to see this in the game. I think they did a good job with it, you know? And I don't think they're going to be put out. Teddy Long taunting, and Bischoff's not gonna interrupt it? Are you gonna let him? There you go, okay. I was gonna say, are you serious? The best GM was the anonymous GM. In any match. If you can't go to distance, I have an email from the anonymous sure Raw General Manager. And the WWE superstars are some of the best conditioned athletes in the world. Okay. Yeah, we're seeing a clear demonstration, like you said, of the cheese where they grapple then Irish whip. I hate that about the AI. You do not need to grapple before you do an Irish whip. You can just do an Irish whip without grappling, but no. In the Rumble, in this, they grapple first, and it's so annoying, dude.
I gotta tell you,
complete oversight. Oh, here we go. Wow. Oh, big reversal from Eazy-E. Dude, there's so many reversals. Why are they going so crazy? Oh, here we go. Another reversal. Wow. Dude, what is going on? Why are they putting in a technical masterpiece here? This really is a good match. This is insane.
If the WWE fans aren't happy, they'll let you know it.
Oh, wait a minute. Did I save after changing it from legend to hard? If I didn't save, then... Because remember, I had to reboot the game when it softlocked. Are we back on legend? I can't recall if I save. I'll have to check after this.
And there's the reversal.
Maybe that's why there's so many reversals here. We'll have to check. If I didn't save, then...
These superstars are on top of their
game. Oh, here we go. It's our first chance to see the casket match minigame in the stream. Bischoff's fighting. He got out.
This has been a great match so
far. I believe my autosave is turned off. I have to manually save.
Wins so nobody gets their feelings hurt?
If someone reminds
that.
Me, I'll check after this.
That in a great match like this.
Unless I just remember myself. Oh, he's going for it again. All right. Bischoff's low on stamina as well. Oh, wait, okay, Bischoff, you better counter this, or else you're done.
This could be over right here.
He did not counter it. It's over. Rest in peace, Bischoff, man. Wasn't a dump truck this time, man. It was a casket. He's out of here. I'm shocked he didn't counter that. We have to hear the Teddy Long team. Bischoff's done. Wow. I'm kind of surprised, though. He wasn't that damaged, so the escape bar was pretty big. I'm kind of shocked he didn't get it. Oh, no. Buried alive. The lightning effect is so cool. Wow. Okay, so buried alive is not out of the equation because that wasn't that bad. As long as it's not like Earl or Brian Hebner where they just yell at you the whole time. Wow. Not gonna lie, I was kind of expecting Bischoff to win. Oh my god, no, I accidentally put Bischoff as the winner in my bracket. Hopefully I can change that. Please let me change that. Okay, good, you can change it, thank god. I almost just scammed Teddy Long. Okay, let's check that difficulty thing here while we're here. No, it's on hard. Wow, they reversed that much on hard. I'm kind of shocked, so I did save. That was crazy. That seemed like a legend to me. Okay, so up next, it's Brian Hebner versus Michael Cole. So I guess we have to do ladder, right? Because Hebner's just going to yell at Cole the whole time. I hate to see it, man. Alright, come on, Cole. You gotta win this, my man. Turn off entrances just in case. Just gonna keep doing that from now on. Okay, is it just me or am I getting the same Lita looing screen 500 times in a row? Alright, here we go. Ladder match. Cole, I really need Cole to win this, man. We need Brian Hebner out of the tournament.
Bienvenue to our fans around the world from
Montreal, Quebec.
Jim Ross here with Jerry.
Alright, well, in a non-shocking turn of events, they grab the ladders immediately.
Tonight's show is a lot better than JR's French.
Alright, come on, Cole. We need to see Cole in a regular match. There's a lot of pressure on him here. What about a last man standing? Do I really want to risk that? I don't know if I want to risk that, man. It might take forever. Oh, here we go. Hip toss immediately. Oh, I was hoping I'd go out of the ring, man. Okay, climbing that ladder. Interesting strategy. Not sure I agree with it.
It's a long way down for whoever loses this fight, JR.
You're a psycho, my dude. You might have just cost yourself the match. Oh my god, no. Cole, get up. Please tell me that's misaligned. And you won't
find oh my god, Brian! He actually landed it! Superstars.
Oh, that camera angle was sick for that. Wow, that was a gamble jumping right there. Oh no, Cole, get up.
There's no off-season in the...
I think he's got it! Does he
have you're saying because the ref... Cole, put... Cole! Cole!
What are you doing, my man? Oh my god! That was the biggest blockhead moment I've ever seen in my life. How tall do you think that ladder was? That ain't reaching, my dude. Are you serious? That was the most disappointing performance of this tournament. All he did was jump out of the ring. Oh my, dude, I'm in shock. I don't even have words for what I just saw. That was the biggest blockhead moment I think I've ever seen in a wrestling game. Oh my god. Wow, now we don't get to see the Muda moveset on Cole. I'm furious right now. That was ridiculous, man. But like I was saying before, you said last man standing because the referees are defaultly set to stay down longer. Maybe we should try that, actually. I don't know. But it's a risk, though, if it doesn't work. Oh my god, that's ridiculous. Michael Cole was like one of the best NPCs, I believe, in my Shut Your Mouth tournament. Good performance. But here, that was... Oh my god, that was disgusting. Unreal. Unreal. If I didn't have integrity, I would overturn that, but I can't, alright? I got integrity. Okay, up next we got Red Movesman versus Vince McMahon. Movesman versus McMahon. Okay, do we want to see something else? But would that actually work? Do the refs just have ref movesets or aren't actual refs? I don't know, to be honest. Maybe it's just if they're in the referee slot, they stay down. Because when you do special referee in this game, no matter who you play, if you get hit down, you do stay down longer. So maybe it's just a case of the game seeing who's in the referee slot to make them stay down rather than the actual referee superstar IDs themselves. I don't know. We could test it, but I'm not too sure. What kind of match do we want for this? I could do steel cage and turn on pin and submission. I'm going to do that, actually. Pin and give up steel cage. It's a red moves, man. I gotta go to the bottom and go up one. I'm not gonna lie, I'm rooting for red moves, man. Judgment Day. Ooh, normal cage or the legend blue cage? And speaking of the legend blue cage, actually, a while back when I was messing around with the SVR 11 mod project, I actually ported over the blue cage from Legend of WrestleMania into that project, so I can make it so you can choose between the two different cages. It was pretty cool. I got it to work. The cage door and everything worked too. Cena's watching over us, my man. Alright, pin and give up or escape here.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to a
Mr. McMahon versus Red Moves Man. Red Moves Man's had a pretty good performance in this tournament thus far.
Another fan in here with a crowbar, I'm telling you. There's a whole lot of cheeseheads in the house tonight. A
lot of cheeseheads.
Green Bay knows that they're about to see the greatest superstars in all of sports entertainment. I can't wait to get started.
So far, the nice moves people are undefeated. Will they keep it up?
I don't think the fans like that one too much. I'm sure this breaks this guy's heart.
It should. These fans are the lifeblood of WWE. And he doesn't give a damn.
He doesn't give a damn. Vince doesn't give a damn about anything.
Slipped out of that one.
All right, going back and forth. It's kind of crazy. Oh my god.
Night after night, the WWE superstars never fail.
Hopefully they do some of the cage animations, but I'm not holding my breath here with the way the AI acts in this game. I wonder if they utilize the cage door now at that minigame.
Right, come on, Red Moves, man. You got this, my dude. Yo, Vince with those jabs, though. He's going in. Alright, slowing it down with the classic wrestling maneuvers here. If Paul White comes to the mat, Vince is done. True. Ring the bell. Now listen, Brian Hebner's the referee of this match. He's potentially scouting out his competition. Is this unfair or what? And was he refereeing his own match, by the way? I wasn't really paying attention.
You know,
he might have been.
Good back and forth action here, but you
man, Cole was so disappointing, though.
No, you don't. And I think we'll see one superstar dominate the match before it's over.
He used the other ref model. Oh, okay, so it wasn't Brian Hebner.
And there's the counter.
And there's the Paul Burchill. Okay, we've seen like a lot of strikes and not many grapples here. Pick it up, my man. So far, I think Bischoff and Teddy Long was my favorite match so far. That was a pretty good match. Wish it would have went on a little bit longer, to be honest. Can't believe I'm saying that, because Dream's been going a while, but... There you go. Cinch it in, my man. Taz is watching backstage right now, scouting out.
I wouldn't be surprised if he got his opponent to tap out right here.
I wonder if we're gonna see any blockhead maneuvers of climbing the cage and getting thrown off.
Man, there's a lot of blood, sweat, and tears.
Vince with the eye rake, unbelievable.
And if these superstars have their way, there's going to be a lot more shed here tonight. Look at these fans. They didn't like that one bit. Yeah, well, you know what? I got some bad news.
Still no
these
damage.
Fans. He don't give a damn what you think.
He don't give a damn. He really doesn't.
Man, a
you better store that, my man.
With that counter.
You better store that finisher in the fridge, my man. There you go.
We've seen this.
You know, I'm kind of a hypocrite telling them to store it, because it's kind of funny. Some people watching my videos like say, like, why do you wait so long to store your finisher? And I do that too, just like the computer. I kind of wait to store it because I like to have the buff a little bit longer. So I push it to the limit too. I kind of live on the edge as well. All right, come on, Red. You're not doing too well here. Imagine if Vince actually wins this tournament.
I think I've got a pretty good idea.
There you go, Red. Hothead Red. You think there's anyone that actually likes Hothead Red better than Red Moveset, man? Probably not, but I'm actually only one of the few people that likes the 2K20 story. Every time I bring it up, people say they hate it, which I kind of understand, to be honest, but... I'm not gonna say it was the best ever, but I didn't hate it.
This capacity crowd is certainly getting its money's worth here tonight, and it's a good.
Yeah, I believe unstored finishers do a little bit more damage, as well as when you have that buff, you actually recover faster. So like in the Rumble, if you're buffed like that, I think you get in like right away. I don't think it's really that much of a difference with damage, but the buff definitely helps.
What a reversal!
What a Paul Burchill. I mean, some people, it's not a bad strategy to store it immediately, because it's a safer strategy, but that's just not what I do. Maybe in certain situations I do, but not always, you know. Most of the time I just let it ride like computer. I kind of just ballpark it when I think it's going to expire, then store it. It's a little bit of a risky strategy, but if you can maintain it, that's not a bad strat. Just requires a little bit more, patience. Oh, what?
I don't think this is just a match anymore.
Wait, can they normally flip over in the apron and cage in this game? I didn't think that was a thing.
They've been beating the hell out of each other.
That's not a thing, right? I don't recall that. Ref, there's a pin? Where are you looking at?
He hasn't done nearly enough to get the pin yet.
I don't recall them flipping over the apron. Maybe I'm just misremembering. Why did that happen? I'm so confused why that happened. Maybe after this tournament, I'll test it off. Maybe on screen, just not put it in the video. Okay, so if Red would have knocked him off the apron, would Vince just have won? Or what would have happened there? I kind of wish he would have hit him now. Do I accidentally have some cheat codes of like ring out always on or something? That would be the next thing to check. If I have that on, that would suck.
These superstars are
I hope that... Okay.
I guess we'll see if something happens. That was really weird, dude. If there's a screw job finish like that, do I have to redo the match or do I just let it ride? Or did Vince McMahon himself put the cheat code on? I don't know. But Red's doing terrible here. This is really disappointing, man. I want to see Red versus Green.
And that's one of the few things we completely
agree on, partner. Tapping. He's tapping.
Oh my, there's
he's tapping.
He's in the driver's seat now.
No doubt, Cole. If your opponent
if someone does a hard Irish whip, they're going to go out of the ring. Much left.
And there's the reversal.
And why not Red versus Blue? Oh! Hey, wait a minute. Red just won. This is a scam. I must have ring out always on or something. I'll check after this, but at least the match didn't end. Oh my god. Oh no, whoa, whoa, come on. It's over. I know, ref's yelling at the crowd for some reason. I must have used that for a video or something and left it on. That was so, I'm glad you knocked him out of the ring though. That was, wow, okay. Vince, are you messing with my cheats or something? I must have missed turning it off when I was putting the cheats for this stream. Oh god! Don't tap. Oh. Come on, Red. Big comeback. Here we go. Bam some top rope maneuvers or something. Honestly, I thought the match would end as soon as he went out of the ring, because I thought the game would consider that being ring out, similar to how in the Rumble, if you like have codes where you can slide out of the ring, you get eliminated. I thought that would be the case here, but apparently not. Maybe you have to actually complete the cage animation for it to register as a win, you know? No! He's done. He's cooked. That low blow kind of sucks, though, because they always get yelled at afterwards, so there's a delay. Cover though.
One, two.
Come on. Oh, he digs deep. So show some fortitude right there and kicks out. Vince is yelling at the ref. You know what? That was a fair kick out, my man. There you go. Big Red comeback. Let's go. Here we go. Oh, them ribs though. Them ribs. Come on. You need to do some aerial maneuvers, my man. I think you're clean, right?
No kidding.
You can't let Vince win, all right?
This could be a pivotal moment in this match. It sure could.
Come on.
There's a lot of pressure being applied in that hole, Cole.
I gotta be honest, I'm more so a fan of Red than Green, man. I think Red's the baby face. Green's here we go. Here we go. Okay, that was just funny. Come on, man. You gotta do something.
Textbook reversal.
That was a textbook Paul Burchill. All right, there you go. Start cooking, my dude.
This is one hell of a performance by some amazing.
You did this move already, but I'll let it slide. That does arm damage, though. That's not going to help him too much in this situation. Can they even climb the cage? I don't know. It might be bugged because of the code. I'm not sure. It seems like they prioritize going for the pin, though, so I guess we're not going to find out. Unless we turn off the ring out code and do another cage match. Oh, here we go. There's some cage animations in the corner, I believe, right? No, he did a running attack. Thank you.
I don't think we'd ever hear the end of it if we cut away here. You're probably right, Tazz. I know I wouldn't want to miss a
grapple.
Second of this act.
No one who's all right, cage animations are working. No, he comboed that into a wall. It's over. Red's done. It was a good effort, my man, but don't cross the boss. Cover. No, unbelievable. That was actually a pretty sick finish, though. But Vince gets the win, man. Red just couldn't overcome the odds, man.
That was a hard-fought battle, but in the end...
Listen, I have a case here. Red got out of the cage. He got out of the cage, man. He's the winner in my books, but Vince is the owner of the company, so... Probably vetoed that right there. Puppets. Yeah, boo him. Red got out of the cage. We all saw it, all right? Red got out of the cage. I don't care under which circumstances he got out of the cage. He was out. You got the Vince Titantron, though. Oh, look at him surveying the scene of what he did. Damn. All right, well, I gotta be honest, I really wanted Red to win, so he either faced Moveset Woman or Moveset Man. Okay, here's your current bracket, and let me check real quick if Ring Out Always On was actually left on. Yes, it was. I see it right here. I missed it. Ring Out Always On. I have it on. Let's double check for other cheat codes. I mean, you guys can't see this, but... I think that was the only one I missed. Alright, it's off now. Actually, I gotta pause and unpause the game real quick to have it apply the disable the cheat. There we go. Alright, so up next is a pretty anticipated match. I'd say it's Green Moves Man versus Green Moves Woman. What kind of match does this have to be, though? Cage was pretty fun, but do we want to do another cage immediately? Let's see. Table match? Alright, let's try it. Hopefully this is not gonna last forever, we'll find out. Alright. They're pretty much equals here, they both know every move animation in the game, man. I don't want Smack, I want something different. Taboo Tuesday, here we go. Oh, that's a good point. Green Moves Man is a little bit more experienced because Green Moves Woman debuted a little bit after, and that's a very good point, alright. Will that come into play here, though? We're going to find out. Yo, I miss Yellow and Blue moveset, man. They're in Just Bring It. Here we go.
This is good old JR Jim Ross here with Jerry the King Lawler.
Eat your vegetables, ladies and gentlemen. You can be just like them. You gotta eat like spinach and asparagus and stuff for like 3 years straight to get this this skin.
So long, ref.
Oh, ref's out. Wow. Oh, Velocity would have been a good call. Oh, man. Too late now. Oh, well. That would have been pretty funny. Dude, Just Bring It tournament would be fun because we got Blue and Yellow moveset, man, and then we got like Cowboy Kurt Angle and all that. Gotta set that up though. I don't know when that's gonna be. That's gonna be a long tournament though. I don't know if I can even do that in one stream unless I'm willing to stream for a long time. Okay, Irish Whip on the table and then walk away. Interesting choice. Not quite sure I agree with that strategy though.
I thought I'd pick the winner before the match started, JR, but now I'm having second thoughts.
Big neck breaker.
Usually I wonder if you've even had first thoughts.
Yeah, just a little putting the table in the corner and then doing absolutely nothing. And then just picking up it. What are you doing? What are you doing? Oh
say,
my
JR,
God.
That table's about the last thing you want to get hit with.
Why do I have a feeling this table match is going to be awful?
If one of these superstars starts
big reversal,
it could be the beginning.
Oh, another reversal. Wow.
That's right, JR. You don't see a lot of matches won with one or two big moves. You
sure one don't. Or two big moves.
You've got to lay the groundwork.
Atomic drop. Here we go. By God. Yeah, there is table damage protection, so they can't just cheese it, unfortunately.
This is beyond just being a match, JR. I think these superstars genuinely hate each other.
There's no love lost between these competitors, that's for sure. If looks could kill, oh man, that'll leave you hurting for certain.
You're not kidding, JR.
Oh God, the impact.
For sure.
I always find it bizarre that the ref's on the table. I always find it bizarre that, they still do the yelling animation when you do like dirty moves and weapons and stuff in matches that are no DQ. It doesn't make any sense, you know. They just get in the way.
There's a determined look in the eyes of these he countered that and made it look easy.
All right, here we go. The moves people.
You gotta respect the commitment and the dedication of these superstars.
That would be funny if one of them had green mist in their moves. That's a good idea, actually.
Every superstar on the roster has had to make more sacrifices.
What are you doing, man? Okay.
It really is like being married to your career. There's not much room for anything else.
And marriage is
oh my god, that the AI in this game drives me crazy after all these years. Hard Irish whip, though, that's kind of rare for the AI to do.
A man doesn't know what true happiness is until he's married. And then it's too late.
Alright, big taunt. Alright, interesting, man. Statement.
I feel okay. So lucky that I'm actually getting to see these superstars wrestle each other.
Me too, King. This one has the potential to become an instant classic.
Instant classic.
What a vicious impact.
Look at that. The AI like strikes at the table and then just puts it down. That's so bizarre.
You've got
what
to
are you doing, my man?
How much
another atomic drop.
Will these superstars be able to withstand?
Damn, with the widescreen, that looks good with that camera angle. You can see like a whole like view of the arena. That's really cool.
They certainly are. I don't know how it's going to end.
Yeah, widescreen hack for these old games is like one of the greatest things ever, man. That stretched 4x3 like hurts my soul seeing that.
Oh boy, the adrenaline is
there. We go. Arm wrench in a table match. Maybe I should have put them both as heals so they get damage for or momentum, better momentum for using the weapons. I mean, they're just putting down the tables every 5 seconds. I think Red's watching backstage crying right now, man. Yeah, destroyed by Vince with that combo in the cage.
I might have issues with certain superstars as human beings, but I respect their in-ring abilities nonetheless.
Damn, I respect these people, all right?
You've got diarrhea of the mouth and constipation of the brain.
Oh man, what a shot from that.
All right, there's still no damage, my man.
Talking about JR. I'm almost sure that was made in America.
Another atomic drop. Another atomic blocked by a table this time. Still no damage in the board. I'm kind of shocked. And I know they're both like really low overall, but still, you know.
No doubt about it, King. This was going to be hell on the anatomy for sure.
Now, here we go. Now they're starting to pick up a bit here. Here we go. Let's see some moves. Stop grabbing the tables every 5 seconds. Another atomic drop. Say it with me.
Showing off for the crowd now.
He's wrestling the match his way.
And I think that move's garbage, man. You got like no momentum from that. Oh, that was aggressive, all right.
Good lord.
Okay, now gonna go to the table with that damage is gonna be good.
What a counter.
Wait, the referee is yelling at her for utilizing a table in a table match. Crazy, huh?
On paper, I wasn't too sure.
It's kind of funny because yeah, since Green knows every move in the game, no matter what you put in his moveset, the moveset is accurate. It's impossible to make a non-accurate Green moveset because he knows every move anyway. So
I'm
slowing it down with like a cravat or something here. What are you doing, my man? All right, pick up a tail and put it down immediately.
So come on, JR. Just between you and me, who are you pulling for in this match?
Yeah, who are you pulling for? Green moves woman or green moves man? I don't know. I've made a pick yet. I don't. Another atomic drop, by the way. I don't think I really care either way. I consider them pretty much the same. There's really not much of a difference between them, you know? Seems they have the same moveset, at least in this context here. I mean, because like I said at the beginning of the stream, normally the moveset people are just alternate attires at the same slot, but I separated them for this video.
And if they can't, they won't be having their arms raised after the match. That's where
he countered that one.
Okay,
perfectly.
Big reversal. Irish whip into nothing. Grabs the table. All right, we cooking now? Nope, it's not gonna swing. You're just gonna walk away.
Top of their game, JR.
Walk away. Set up the table 40 times.
You almost forget about the years of training and sacrifice.
Still no finishers here, man. This is a. I think I'm not gonna do a tables match again. Oh, God.
Let me tell you, when a wooden table. table meets flesh and bone.
Oh, what is she doing? Jump. Please jump. 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 What are you doing? Stop. What are you goofballs doing? Oh, no. What is this?
A lot of blood.
All right, good. She fell off. My God.
Have been shed in that very ring.
And I think there's going to be a lot more shed here tonight.
No doubt about that, King.
This match is sponsored by Green Giant Vegetables. Oh, gut wrench on the table. Oh, my God. That would have been insane. He actually landed on the table there. Oh, here we go again. Back with this nonsense. Oh, my God.
What do you think of the match so far, JR?
I think these superstars are putting on
back elbow.
Hell of an exhibition here tonight, King. I can't wait to see what happens next.
Okay, he somehow ended up on the table
he's
after that. I don't know why they're not striking. They're trying to grapple him on top of the table. That's so bizarre.
Oh, man.
Oh,
I guess that's better.
Oh, he's just going to walk away. It's more important to set up the second table.
What a reversal.
What a Paul Burchill. Okay, I believe Green Moves Woman HUD is on the right.
Classic, and I think these fans are too stupid to realize it.
How can you say that, King? How can you insult the intelligence of these WWE fans?
Oh, here we go.
I heard that we gave them an IQ test.
Do they have to be at least orange or is yellow to get the job done? Oh, it's over. Green Moves Man gets the win with a power bomb. It's finally over. I don't think I'm going to watch a table match again, man. That was horrible.
There's no better way to prove who's the better superstar.
All right, Green Moves Man is the only moves person standing. Red's gone, Green Moves Woman's gone. He's the sole representation of the moveset system here. Good win, good win. Getting closer to the end, still got a little bit of ways to go here. All right, here's your current bracket. Now up next, it's Tazz versus Lilian Garcia. If Tazz loses this, I'll be shocked, but it should be easy. Or do we want to give Lilian a little bit of help here and pick a match that would help her out? But what would even help her out, you think? I don't know if anything really would. I really don't want to see another ladder match, so I might just rule that out. We're gonna go back to a backstage brawl, parking lot brawl this time. It's Tazz! But here's another point to consider. Remember, Tazz is my pick to win this, so why would I want to give Lilian an advantage? I don't know. Right, here we go, Triple H is watching over us. He wants to shovel back from that Buried Alive match, he's pissed. All right, here we go. I mean, there are environmental grapples she could utilize, so there we go. Remember, if Tazz wins this, then I correctly predicted all three winners of these NPC tournaments. That would be insane if I pull it off. Oh, she can't even pick him up, man. This is over. This is over, man. Airplane spin. See how he follows up after this. Okay. Let's see if the computer grabs the horns off of JBL's limo. I remember when I first showed that off on video, I got a lot of comments of people saying they didn't even know you could do that. And to be honest, for the longest time, I didn't know either until one day as a kid, I was playing against the computer in parking lot brawl and they straight up just went over and grabbed it. It blew my mind because I didn't even know you could do that. And I never saw any information about it anywhere. So I thought that was crazy. Never knew about that until the computer showed me. Pretty awesome. Oh, do it. Is he gonna do it? Oh, I thought he was gonna go for it. He's walking towards it. Then he walked back. Oh, environmental grapple? Oh, no. Oh, my God. Someone arrest Tazz. This man's a psycho. Oh, my God. Dude, she's getting absolutely obliterated here. That animation's sick, though. Dude, Lillian's done. There's no way.
Oh, environmental grapple. That's a rookie mistake. You gotta wait a split second to grapple, otherwise you do that cheese or you do a normal grapple move. That's a rookie mistake, man. You can't be doing that. Oh, here we go. Taz going in. Big shoulder block. Slowing it down with a leg lock in the parking lot. Man, getting some stamina here. All right, come on. I want to see my true favorite animation in this game, the ether. What are you doing, you blockhead? Striking an opponent, laying against the environment? All right, here we go. Taz doing Taz things now. They're loving this corner so far. Not even going towards the ambulance or anything. Favorite animation is a limo finisher. That's a good one, too. It's hilarious, too. Oh, submission type B. Is this going to be it? Oh, she got out. Wow. There you go. Got him yellow, using the environment to your advantage here. Even though I don't want you to win here, because I want to have my pick. My pick. Oh, she's red now. He's almost got a finisher, too, man. He could cheese off a regular move. Oh, neck break. He might pin off this. Oh, Taz mission. Taz mission! Taz mission! Pause and unpause. Fix that real quick. It's over. Submission type B. We can't even see because of the hood. She's done. I can't even see, but... Oh. And she taps out. We can't see it. There's no proof, but the game said so. Taz gets the win. Are you proud of what you've done, my man? The police are going to be showing up soon. You're lucky there's no police NPCs in this game, my man. You'd be arrested right here. All right, Taz moves on to the semifinals. Welcome to the squared circle. Whoa there, tough guy. Newcomers, I just like you to know that. Hopefully you can handle yourself amongst the lions and wolves. All right, so Teddy Long versus Brian Hebner, which means I guess we have to go back to the ladder match because of the Brian Hebner referee cheese. So we have to suffer potentially one more ladder match. Hopefully Hebner doesn't win. Please God. SmackDown. Imagine Random being getting SmackDown. That's happened so many times. Don't forget this guy's WrestleMania 19. True. And apparently they're trained by The Rock because they have like The Rock's punches and stuff. Alright, come on. Teddy Long, you gotta win this for the purity of the tournament so we don't have to keep seeing ladder matches because of the Brian Hebner yell at you cheese. Wow, not immediately going for the ladder? They waited at least 3 seconds. I'm shocked. They waited a good 3 seconds that time. Crazy. Oh, this should be interesting. There's no doubt in my mind that the SmackDown... That knee doesn't even knock him off. Toronto the show of a lifetime. All right, come on, Teddy. You got this, my man. You defeated Bischoff. You have no problem with Brian Hebner here. Wild man strats, though. It's obvious these superstars have studied each other real carefully, Cole. No question. He's going to do that knee again, isn't he? He's got a finisher off that. Against an opponent you haven't done your homework on.
I have never seen two competitors more determined to beat the living hell out of each other.
That finish is going to expire, my dude. Oh, no. Another hip toss. We've seen 40 of those this stream. I'm sure they have it, Cole. Oh, Teddy's, oh. That looked weird for a second.
Soup bones!
Okay, interesting knee. Oh my god. Teddy might jump out of the ring here. Oh, okay. Alright. I gotta say, out of all the wrestling games, simulating SVR06 ladder matches might be the worst thing ever. I'm trying to think of something else that's worse for simulating in wrestling games, but this is awful. Just as bad as I remember it. This is not a
did either superstar.
Another hip toss. SBR 06 TLC title. Actually, that's kind of fair too, because there's more weapons to grab every 5 seconds.
Well, I think this one's pretty much a foregone conclusion. Not too tough to figure out who's gonna win this one. Only one of these superstars.
It's actually kind of unpredictable to figure out who's gonna win, with how wild this AI is in this game. The worst elbow of all time, and he actually can't. Oh, he broke his neck. Get up there. Go. Climb, Teddy. Climb. Oh my God. Reach. Climb the ladder, kid. Make yourself famous. Come on, Teddy. Brian Hebner is checking on Brian Hebner. Teddy Long. Let's go. Oh my God. No more ladder matches. I'm so happy, dude. Austin's happy too, and so am I. Thank God. Teddy Long moving on. Good God, dude.
These fans aren't happy about
the new replica WWE champion, Theodore Long. Alright, get the car ready. Rip up the car to run him over. Alright, Teddy Long, I gotta be honest, I wasn't expecting too much of him in this tournament, but he kind of surprised me. You could be looking at the winner of the tournament, folks. You never know. Yeah, we just see a Titan Shine now, let's go. Guy in the car is a sign that we want tables. Sir, are you aware how bad the AI is with weapons? Are you sure you want tables? Are you positive about that? Because I do not want tables. Let's go, the new replica WWE champion. True, he does have to go through Taz, which is easier said than done, man. Thank God the refs are gone, man.
The time comes when we must stand and fight against the odds. And the size of the opponent can make no difference to be a real champion.
That's fair, right? Ladder matches are worse than 2006. Oh, God. I kind of liked when they introduced the, like in 07 with the sweet spot system. I like that better than just pressing circle and waiting to pull it down. All right, here we go. We're getting towards the end, man. This tournament is significantly longer than the other two we did in the stream, but it's all right. I've been enjoying it. Even through the annoying AI issues, it's all right. So we got Vince McMahon versus Green Moves Man. All right, I think I'm back now. Yeah, so my net actually didn't crash. My OBS just stopped responding. And thankfully, my video file did not get corrupt from what I see, at least. I mean, I could still pull the stream if I wanted the video. My local recording's higher quality. So that sucked. I thought it was my net at first, then I look over and I see my OBS stop responding. I'm like, oh, great. but anyways, we got Vince McMahon versus Green Moveset Man. So here we go. We're back. That was so lame, man. OBS, dude. All right, here we go, though. Welcome to this is a regular match, by the way. Single straight up match. There we go. If Vince McMahon wins, he would have defeated Green and Red back to back, or Red and Green back to back.
We got a show for you tonight. Hey, Cole, we're in the desert. This is nuts. Every SmackDown show is bigger and better than the ones that came before, and tonight's gonna be bigger than all of them.
That's a bold statement, partner, but I can't disagree.
Yeah, I need to fully check the file, but from what I've seen, it's all right. Because even OBS warns you, if you're recording an MP4 format, if your OBS crashes, the file's gone. But if you use MKV, the file should be fine, which I do use MKV and then just convert it to MP4, so should be good. Otherwise, I'm going to be pulling my own stream, which will be slightly lower quality. Vince taking out the ref.
As well chuck the rule book out the window now.
And that yep. I'm actually throwing the rule book out my window as we speak. I mean, as soon as the ref gets up, I have to go grab it real quick, though.
What a deadly maneuver this is.
You're not kidding, Cole.
Big leg. This could potentially end it. We haven't seen one DQ. We've gotten lucky. Big elbow. Ref right in the way. You better watch out, my dude.
This is completely
if it ends in DQ, but if it ends in DQ, we're just gonna let it ride because it is what it is. It's with an intense headlock here. That headlock is not as good as the romping, stomping headlock, alright?
You can't win fair and square, so he tries to screw his opponent out of the victory.
Yo, Vince is going wild. What is this? Got a crazy amount of low blows and chokes and headlocks. Big jab. All right. It just completely missed. Storing the finisher out as well. Some fans could still be protesting that Red won that cage match. Both feet touched the floor. We all saw it. I mean, to be fair, that ring out always on was not supposed to be left on, but.
No doubt, Cole. These WWE superstars put their bodies on the line night after night.
He's tapping. He's tapping. Ring the bell. Ring the bell. He's tapping. Yeah, I'm cheering for Green this match. I'll make it clear. I'm cheering for Green. I'll make my stance clear. No! That was a double low blow combo.
Nobody sticks around long after taking a finisher like
that. Did like no damage though.
Great reversal.
Great pulverchal. I just want to cover 07 soon so I can use Paul Burchill, man. One of my favorite characters, to be honest. Or superstars, I should say.
How much longer can they keep this up?
I don't know, Tazz.
Triple H clothesline thing, all right.
It's going to get a lot worse before it's over.
Red's watching backstage, man. And Green moves woman, too. She could have been in here, but Green moves man got the win in that table match. Big hip toss, though.
They were going to wind up against each other sooner or later.
There were times when it seemed like it wasn't going to happen, but I can't tell you
right, come on.
How glad I am.
Green, you gotta get
did.
Fired up. You gotta get that's psyched sure. up, my man.
You know, anytime you
eat some spinach like Popeye and go crazy.
You're guaranteed to get a hell of a show.
And that's exactly what we're seeing here tonight.
Oh, Austin Stomp thing. By God.
Boy,
Vince is doing all this in a suit, by the way. The disrespect, my man.
Go at all.
And that's what makes the WWE so exciting.
The oh, Vince with the retreat.
The
so this is a regular match, and sometimes in this game,
exactly
what
you're going to see.
The dirty superstars get themselves disqualified on purpose, so hopefully that doesn't happen. I understand kind of why they did that feature, but it's honestly kind of annoying, if you ask me.
These superstars are on fire.
What a Green's got to get all zeked up. I'm getting all zeked up just thinking about it, man.
Tell you all the WWE superstars are legit all right.
I'm just more so excited that Tazz is still in the tournament. My pick, I could potentially pull off the trifecta. Three successful picks in three tournaments.
And that's the name of the game called intensity.
Intensity. Wow. Counters the drop kick with an elbow. That looks so weird.
Looks like they might be taking this match.
All right, come on, Green. There you go. Get all fired up, my man.
The pace of the match may have slowed. But the intensity of
toe kick to the back, big elbow. Here we go.
You can say that again. Waiting for your opponent to make
actually, in this case, we decided to put it on hard because Legends is too many reversals, so we wanted to see a little bit more move variety, so we put it on hard. There you go. Use that clean system to your advantage, my dude. I approve. Keep it going. Oh, but Vince is fired up.
He slipped out of that one.
There you go. You better store that, my man. I got the fridge open. Put that finisher in there. Store it.
He's got this crowd solidly behind him.
Oh no.
And now he's going to give them
come on,
exactly
Green. No long leg lock. Say goodbye to the finisher,
that's
Green.
A huge distraction in my opinion.
It's expiring. It's gone. Wow. That was actually a high IQ play by Vince doing a long animation
that
to waste the finisher time.
Dead.
Can also do things like dragging your opponent and stuff like that. It's a little bit dishonorable, but you know what? Gets the job done. All right, Ultimate Dragon takedown thing, very nice.
Incredible display of athletic ability here tonight.
Okay, Green's got him yellow now. Here we go.
He's a WWE superstar for crying out loud.
There we go.
They're the greatest athletes in the world.
True enough, Tazz. There's no off season for them.
There should be a moveset, man, who the color of his limbs change depending on his body damage. Like, imagine like if his torso and head were actually yellow on his model. Like, that'd be pretty insane. Rainbow moves, man. That's the DLC I want. Hard Irish whip from Vince. Okay. I can respect that.
Right after night, the WWE
oh, here we go. This better not end in count out. What happens if it ends in a double count out? Do I just, did they just both? Do I gotta disqualify them both and the next person just gets a bye or what? Because this is to get into the finals. That would suck. There'd be no finals match. All right, there you go.
Right,
come on, Green. You can do this, my man. Unless we have to do some sort of sudden death rule type thing. I don't know. That's never happened in one of my NPC tournaments, to my knowledge, at least.
You're like a real jerk when somebody counters you like that.
Ooh, reversal fest. Here we go. We're cooking now. We're cooking.
This has been a great match so far, and I think it's pretty obvious which way it's going.
Oh, really?
Is it? It's pretty back and forth.
Actually...
Watch it. He reversed it.
Atomic drop. Shades of the table match. Oh, 40 of those in that match.
You never know what to expect from these superstars, Cole.
Come on, Green. You can do this, my man.
60 seconds or 60 minutes.
Well, it wouldn't break my heart if they went for an hour, Taz. I'm really enjoying
Vince
this
is
match.
Loving those jabs, man. They're pretty successful, I would say.
He anticipated that move perfectly.
Yeah, but that's right. This is the semifinals. We're getting close to the end, man. Stream's almost over, man.
Looks to me as this can go down in a
okay, Vince regrouping, all right. He's close to a finisher, though.
About every match has that
wow. Great reversal.
There you go.
Three.
Imagine if I actually do that SVR06 removed characters tournament. Since the only available removed characters publicly right now are Luther Reigns and Maven, it would just be two people. That's it.
The perspective of somebody who has a neck that resembles a
man, I really hope we see some more betas get posted online. Those are the most hype moments ever, though, when that happens. There you go. Did this move like four times, I think, but you know what? It's all right.
I really can't task.
There you go. All right. I mean, you're pretty close to a finisher anyway, so. And he did the wrong animation.
Hell out of me here too.
Rip.
And I think it's that unpredictability that makes these superstars so exciting to watch.
So exciting to watch. Well, I guess, would you consider Hulk Hogan Young to be a removed character? It's just, it's the same slot as Hogan Age, just the model's different. So I don't know if that's necessarily considered a removed character, even though he has a different name. I don't know. That's up for debate, I suppose. I don't really know.
I've
been slowing down with the leg lock. All right. Methodical pace here. Got a finisher. I think Green might be, he's reeling right now.
It usually means that they ain't got much left. That was a textbook reversal.
There you go. Come on, do what Vince did to you. Waste his finisher. Let's see a leg lock or something. Come on, you gotta stand the attack. He's gonna store that. Get out there. Green to the top? You're crazy, my man! Oh, God. He's stealing his taunt. And it got interrupted. Wow, I can't believe. I can't believe Vince did that. He used his finisher to steal a taunt. Oh, my God. Unexpected moment. That's arrogance right there. It's either arrogance or a blockhead move, depending on your perspective, but oh my God.
You gotta come ready for the battle.
It's kind of funny, when I do my challenge mode video, there's a challenge where you gotta interrupt a stolen taunt, and that's actually easier said than done, because the AI doesn't necessarily steal your taunts that much. So, like, that's gonna be annoying to do that challenge. You can't do the controller cheese, I believe, plugging the second controller, but. And I believe only dirty superstars will steal taunts. I don't think clean guys ever do it. The computer I'm talking about, if I remember correctly. And also, you know, I have to be tactical about it. I have to face someone that has, or play as someone that has long taunts. So when they do steal it, I can interrupt it right away, you know. Like, I don't want to play as Rock because he has, like, one taunt that's super quick. So, I don't know. I got to look at the longest. I think Triple H has some long taunts, right? Oh, no! Whoa, whoa! Green counters immediately, though. Very nice. Yeah, I would definitely do Crush Hour videos. I love that game. I'd love to cover that. I would have a hard time deciding who I want to play as, though. I think I talked about it earlier in the stream, but the two people I played as a lot in that game were Rock and Rob Van Dam. Those are my two favorites.
No matter what call you make, you're going to get on the bad side of at least one superstar.
All right, this is actually a good match. I mean, I feel like Green could be getting more momentum here, but he's still hanging in there regardless. There you go. Maybe the psycho needs to go back to the top rope. Maybe that's the answer here. There you go.
They'll just keep going.
They certainly don't look like they're going to give anything less than 100%.
Big leg countered. All right, good, good. There we go. Green is cooking now. There we go. He's cooking right now. I don't know what he's making. Maybe some stir fry with some vegetables, eating his greens. But he's cooking right now. Man is cooking. There you go. Stay in the attack.
Oh,
there you go. Clean moves.
Nothing wrong.
I don't know where you're going though, but all right. Oh boy. Oh, he baits Vince and runs in the ring.
He's going up.
Oh, this is risky. Oh, dude, he might have been able to make that with that double elbow drop. That might have actually reached that far, to be honest. But he got down. Vince, you all right? Wait, what's going on here? Green's regrouping. You know what? Fair. That's fair. Fair strategy. Regroup, reassess, reevaluate, get back in the game. Going to the barricade. Oh, I thought he was going to jump. Honestly, barricade aerial attacks are a pretty good strat for getting momentum quick if you're a clean guy.
You can't let your opponent think you're easy pickings.
Well, I wouldn't consider any of these superstars to be easy pickings.
Easy pickings?
No matter how beaten up they get.
Wow, he recovered immediately from getting thrown in the turnbuckle. Baseball slide, let's go! Oh my god, that was a play right there, interrupting the taunt. You better store that, my man. Green might have, don't use it on the outside. Thank god, store it. I feel like it's kind of rare to see a computer hit a baseball slide, to be honest, because you had to be close to the apron to hit that.
And there's a reason for that, Tazz. There are no off-season
was SmackDown vs. Raw the final WWE game where you had a...
You're performing every week of the
year. Oh, did Green just try his finisher? Or I was looking at chat. He lost his finisher somehow. Was SmackDown vs. Raw the final WWE game to have you fight Vince as a WrestleMania opponent? Let's see. You might be right. I'm thinking of WrestleMania 19, but that was before SmackDown vs. Raw, so that doesn't count. Yeah, I think you're right. I can't think of another game where you do that in season mode. Unless someone else knows, maybe.
This one's gonna keep on going until someone
keep on going. Oh, he tried to possum pin swipe. Oh no, it can't end like this. The submission minigame. Green, you gotta dig deep, man. Think about your fallen moveset, people, man. Red, green moves, women, they're watching in the back cheering for you. You gotta dig deep, brother. You gotta dig deep. It can't end like this. You gotta show some fortitude, brother. Some fighting spirit. You gotta dig deep, Green. It can't end like this. No. Oh, you gotta dig deep. Please. Oh, Green with the reversal. He didn't even go for the escape. He went for the reversal. Gets the momentum here. He could do a finisher after this. Here we go. Green's fired up. The crowd's behind him. Here we go. Get him off. Do a finisher right away. Here we go. The reversal animation, by God. Store it. Store that right now or use it. Here we go. Store it. Store it. Use it. Do something. Store it, please, for God's sake. Oh, my God. Yeah. Okay, here we go. All right. Okay. Wow. By the way, yeah, that reversal animation, when I'm playing personally, I don't go for that because that's risky. That's high risk, high reward because you have to wait for it to pass the escape section. So your chances of failing there and losing the match are pretty high if you don't time it just right. So that was impressive by Green. He Green landed in the red zone right there. That was for red right there. Red moves, man. Oh, my God. Oh, dirty pin? You're supposed to be a good guy, but I'll allow it. Cover. Vince kicks out at one. That's a statement right there. No, don't hit the ref. This can't end in DQ. This is a really good match. Please. Okay, instead of doing a rebound grapple, you just do that.
This one could still go either way, Cole.
Yeah, I always go for the blue zone too, because the red is so risky. It's kind of cool to see that. Oh, please don't hit the ref. Please, God, don't do a strike. Stop! Stop! Please! I'm getting so worried right now. It's a really good match. It can't end in DQ. Oh, Vince with an arm bar? Alright. Submission type B, alright. He's got like no arm damage though. And even if you can't make your opponent tap out, by the way, that sleeper hold minigame is really cool. There's also a double KO minigame in this game. I love those minigames. They're really cool. They should have kept those going. Yeah, Vince has a finisher. I'm a little scared here. Green. Maybe we should turn off DQ in all future matches just to eliminate that risk because we're in the semifinals. Oh, no. Low blow. Green, come on. Kick out, Green. Kick out, Green. No! Vince McMahon gets the win. He's defeated Green and Red. No! Damn that Vince McMahon! No! Oh my god, that was such a good match though. Oh my, that was like one of the best simulated matches I've ever seen in 06. Oh my god, Green had that hope spot where he was coming back, but it just wasn't enough, man. He gave it his all though, you gotta respect that, but Vince McMahon is moving on to the finals. Oh my god. Here's your updated bracket. Actually, I need to, I'm gonna move it over here. Semi-finals, Taz versus Teddy Long. Teddy Long kind of been the underdog in this tournament here. He's been solid performances. He's hanging in there. Oh my goodness, dude. We're gonna do another single match. Semi-finals gonna be pure straight up wrestling matches. But I'm gonna turn off DQ for this just to eliminate that risk. Oh my god. I'm so... Oh wait, I just said I was gonna turn off DQ. Let's actually keep our word here. I'm gonna turn off DQ but leave on count now. I'm crazy, alright? Oh my god. Dude, that was such a good match. Jesus. He actually did the reversal animation on the sleep roll. That was great. You gotta respect Green's effort there.
To our fans around the world from Montreal,
oh, Teddy Long can't even pick up Taz either. Plus the overall disadvantage. He's done. I don't care how good you've been performing this tournament, man. You're done, though. Taz has got this.
Well, there's no question of that, King.
My personal pick of the tournament, Taz.
And so am I. So what are we
he's done. I'd be shocked if he overcomes this. It's possible, but unlikely, I'd say. Oh, immediate triangle hold. By God. Just tap, man.
He's really cranking up the pressure on that hold, JR. He sure is. There's no doubt he's looking for the submission right
Dude,
here.
Vince's low blows are no joke, man. I think we're actually going to... Whoever came up with the idea of three stages of hell for the finals, I think I'm actually going to do that.
This has all the makings of an instant...
Instant classic. I don't know if they can live up to the Vincent Green match. That was good, dude. I really enjoyed that. I got scared though. I was gonna end in DQ by hitting the ref.
What does he think he's doing?
There we go.
Showing off for the crowd now. He's wrestling the match his way, and I think it's gonna pay off.
Backslide. All right. Big rope break. Okay.
You're not gonna get him with that one.
I don't think this is gonna work, JR.
Man, the weight class gap, man. I remember I had to stick with my word of not adjusting their weight classes, so some people just naturally are at a disadvantage, man. It's the way it is. Some of the games you can actually turn off the weight detection, which if that was an option here, I would have, but this game is not one of them.
No doubt about that, King. The fans are getting their money's worth here tonight.
His opponent telegraphed that one.
It's Taz. Belly to belly Taz flex. Here we go. Oh, Taz mission. All right. Taz mission. Let's go ahead and pause and unpause that. It's going to be a rope break, though. All right. Yeah.
Rope break.
And he's clean, so he's not going to hold on to it.
I'll tell you what, King. The WWE superstars.
Okay, that was an interesting choice going to the top rope when he's right there. That was
What do you mean just about, JR?
That was a bold maneuver by him, but it did not work out.
That you can see athletes of this caliber?
I was just going for a little humility there, King. I'm not surprised.
Dude, I really thought Green was going to come back after he reversed that sleeper minigame. I thought we were seeing that epic comeback, but he got shut down a little bit later on. Man. Vince McMahon, ultimate heel.
And the dedication of these superstars to their careers.
No question.
Dude, Vince could win this tournament with all the controversy with him going on right now. Unbelievable.
Sacrifices than any other professional athlete I know.
It really is like being married to your career.
I'm just glad we don't have to watch any more ladder matches. Those are miserable to watch in this game.
Is a subject which you happen to be something of an authority. Isn't that right, King?
Yeah, chokehold, rope break.
A man doesn't know what true happiness is until he's
married. Teddy Long staying on the attack. He's almost got a finisher, actually. Are we underestimating him? Are we just being practical? Accepting reality and the facts we're given here.
I don't know. I'm a fan of everybody in this match, JR. But you've got to respect their dedication to this business.
This business.
King. I don't have to like everyone.
There we go. Taz shutting him down now.
that they've all worked long and hard.
It's like Taz's stamina management's not good, but will it actually matter? I don't know.
It's like he read his opponent's mind.
Green lost to Vince, and he's probably furious and going to the AEW game right now. He's actually being deleted from my game file.
These superstars, it really drives home the fact that Raw is the dominant brand of sports entertainment.
Oh, there's no doubt about that, JR. There's not a
Yeah, the whole Vince thing is crazy. Like, I think it's even crazier that like he like went on TV and like, you know, did all that stuff and like these reports that supposedly he's like not even like fazed by it backstage or whatever. It's kind of crazy with all this stuff going on. It's gonna be interesting to see where this fully goes, you know. Some people are saying he's donezo after all this. Like, it's even gotten worse recently. So, is he truly done, or is he gonna go through this, man? I don't know. Someone made a funny joke on Twitter, though, that made me laugh so bad. Like, Vince asking to borrow Big E's neck brace, because as a reference to the steroid trials, where Vince wore the neck brace during the trials to get a little bit more sympathy. Like, even though he was pretty much recovered at that point. Oh, that was really funny, though.
There's the reversal.
Theodore Long's got a finisher, though. Maybe I should be paying more attention to this match, actually. Better store that match. Oh, running spear! My God! Are we going to see some yellow cheese in the tournament?
Been reversed.
Cover! It's the weight class animation. Taz kicks out and gets a finisher. Ooh. Whoa, I thought we were gonna see some yellow cheese, my man. I don't know if yellow cheese is even really that common in SVR06, to be honest with you.
No matter who wins this one,
Taz mission, the behind version! Taz mission! Taz mission! Submission type B, is that enough? He got out. Wow. He's gonna try to pin him off that, alright. Oh, no. He got reversed. Oh, what is this? Crossface, okay. A little bit of damage here. Submission type A.
Could this be a tap out? It isn't. The hold can't be broken. You can't take this kind of pain for long.
Yeah, that is a good point. Vince is no stranger to controversy, and he's still here, so that could be telling of what's gonna happen, you know. Pretty
Look
good
at the
point.
Damage that has been inflicted here. I don't care who he thinks he is. He can't take much more of this.
Yeah, the whole Brian Pillman's widow incident kind of irks me, because that's so low. Like, how can you in your right mind justify that? I don't really see how that's okay, you know.
Watch out! He reversed.
I think didn't he like talk about it before, like saying something like you know, like giving her a platform to talk, but it kind of felt like taking advantage of a situation that someone was grieving to me. That's just my opinion. I'm someone who loved Brian Pillman too, so maybe I'm biased, but that's just how it came across to me personally. You know? Like mostly because of the fact of how soon it was, you know? Man, Teddy might be done here, though.
You can look at any professional sport you want, JR. And you won't find more
Irish ripping the punch.
The WWE superstars.
You're not wrong, King. They compete every week until they are physically incapable of continuing.
Dude, Teddy Long's fighting, though. You gotta respect it, man. He's hanging in there. I mean, I'm not gonna say he's doing, like, incredibly well, but he's hanging in there. Oh, ribs coming into play, though. Head arm Taz Plex. Oh, Taz mission gets reversed. Oh, here we go. I love that animation, too. Okay, Taz actually going for stand. Oh, he stops. Okay. Man's doing all this in a suit. Pretty impressive. Oh, here we go. Just straight punches. Nothing fancy about those. He's going to pin off that. Is that enough?
No trouble kicking out.
Okay. Pick zero. God, that was very disappointing.
Oh, man.
Oh, it's a little bit risky. Pays off. Got a lot of momentum. That was big risk, big reward right there.
You know, JR, when I saw this match on paper,
yeah,
I wasn't too sure.
Pull back attack.
But it's turned out a lot better than I thought it would.
I just love them those toe kicks right there.
I knew this was going to be a terrific matchup.
Terrific matchup.
You're just talking through your hat.
Oh, here we go, Taz. By God. He's out. Taz mission. Taz, is this enough? Is he going to be in the ropes, though? No. Taz mission cinched in. It's submission type B. This could be it. It's over. Taz moves on to the finals to face Vince. Wow, Teddy Long, man. I respect the effort, but it was just too big of a mountain to overcome.
Well, one match doesn't decide anything, King. I'd love to see them go at it again.
All right, well, it's all come down to this. All come down to this, the stream. Three non-playable character tournaments. We're on the last match of the last one there. But we're doing three stages of hell, all right?
Open up my eyes. Save me what's been
I'll update my bracket real quick. Here we go, the finals. Vince McMahon versus Taz. Gonna do three stages of hell. If it actually comes down to the third match, that's gonna be pretty hype. Ooh, here we go. Now we have some choices here. So let's see. I'm not doing ladder or table, I'll tell you that. Probably TLC either. How about we open with a steel cage? Okay, you're not allowed. Are you not allowed to pick Iron Man? That's a scam. I thought you could do that. Guess not. First blood. Okay. Well, this is a tough choice here. Last Man Standing makes the most sense to me because it's like, you know, the final match. You gotta incapacitate your opponent in the final battle. But it might take... I'm doing it. Screw it. I was about to go in this whole rant, but I'm doing it. Alright. It's Taz! Here we go. Taz, Mr. McMahon. Three stages of hell. You know what? This is taking place at WrestleMania. I'm picking. I'm not randoming this one. Oh, I can't even do match rules. Hopefully it doesn't crash then. Or soft locked, I should say. Oh no. Alright, regular. It doesn't even let you choose the cage, man. It's a scam. Alright, here we go. I don't have that ring out always on by accident this time. That's off. So here we go. First match.
This sold out crowd is on its feet here.
Oh, wait a minute. I just realized something.
Here with Taz at ringside.
It doesn't let you pick pin or give up, so they have to escape in this. Is this gonna take forever?
I'm with you on that, partner.
Because it just said steel cage on the menu and you can't go to the match rules in three stages of hell. So I don't know if pin and give up is going to even be on in this. And they get up pretty fast in this game, man. Unless they do the door animation. Oh, man. Well, buckle in, boys. This might be a long one. This might be a long finale to the stream here.
He saw that one coming.
Oh, God. Mistake could have potentially been made here. I could actually use codes to force pin and give up always on.
Week after week after week, Cole. Trust me.
I don't doubt it, Taz. The WWE superstars don't get an offseason.
Taz, by the way, commentating his own match in the finals.
Not physically capable of continuing.
All right, Taz, not a lot of pressure here, but my picks from the SmackDown 2 Cut Legends and the Rumble Roses non-playable characters came true, so I can make it 3-for-3, my man, if you get the win here, so no pressure, but no pressure, you know?
I gotta tell you, Cole, I thought I had this thing figured out, but now I got no idea how this is gonna end up.
Neither do I, Taz.
Taz loving that. We already got Vince yellow here.
That makes it so exciting.
No doubt, Cole. I've seen superstars get a huge advantage over
a huge advantage.
Still lose the match.
Man, I wish I had to just bring it one set up because I don't have anything to do tomorrow, so I could have like stayed up as late as I want. But I guess I could maybe record or work on some other projects after the stream. Or I could just do nothing too. It's another option. So I got nothing to do.
And there's the counter, Cole.
Spare.
The pride in the hearts of these competitors might be the only thing that's keeping them going.
And
come on,
pride's a powerful emotion. But when you just plain run out of gas.
Finish the Here Comes the Pain 2.0 season. Funny, a decent amount of people ask me to finish that, but I probably have the mem card somewhere. So all I remember is I was gonna go into a program with Brett and then I stopped. Like, imagine stopping when you're gonna go into a program with your favorite wrestler. I just stopped and I never picked it up again. Hasn't that mod been like updated a lot since then though? So it's probably outdated.
And having to deal with emotional as well as physical.
physical
pain. Oh, Vince has got a finisher
he
here.
That move perfectly.
Like, I don't even know if I have the most updated version of that, or like if my mem card would now conflict with the updated version if character slots were switched around. Well, I
certainly don't envy the referee in this match. No kidding.
All right, come on, Tazz. Tazz is actually not doing as well as I would hope here. Vince loves those jabs, man. They're effective, too. No! Oh, blow. Oh, and he went for a toe kick immediately and he got reversed. Also interesting, Vince is not using his secondary finisher. I think he's always done the primary finisher, right? He has a stunner as a secondary finisher. Oh, my God. Vince is going crazy. Come on, Tazz.
Looking forward to this match all night long, Cole.
There you go, choke him out. That's a shoot right there.
Anticipated matchups in recent weeks. And usually when you have that kind of hype,
there we go.
Really tough to live up to the expectations.
Yeah, this is definitely escape only. This is gonna be interesting, man.
Any trouble doing that. They sure aren't.
I mean, people get up decently quick in this game, you know.
There's the reversal, Cole.
There's a fine line between, like, recovery time in the games, you know, like, I think it's cool, like, some of the games that have the option, like, remember the very long recovery time in, like, 2K20 when I did that Becky Lynch WrestleMania challenge? That was so annoyingly hard. The very long recovery in that game, you stay down forever. Whoa, whoa! Okay, Vince is playing like a blockhead, though. He's attacking immediately after the low blow instead of, like, climbing out. Do I have anything for Anthology? I actually haven't picked that up in a while, but the last things I worked on was I added some win animations because I figured out how to add them to some superstars, not everybody. So I added like I think it's like 10 or 11 win animations. Like, I'm talking about adding, not replacing. And then I added a few moves. So I've been experimenting with moves on and off. I still got a test, but I want the first beta version to ship with a few added moves, like a fixed version of Hogan's leg drop I did, Mandible Claw I did, and Goldberg Spear and Jackhammer, because the Goldberg Spear is actually not in 11, so like on the Goldberg preset moveset, he uses like the Ashley Spear, and like I can't have Goldberg do that spear. Like, no disrespect to Ashley and her spear, but it's Goldberg, he needs to have his spear, his intense spear, you know, so I need that back in the game. Do I have the Lion Salt? No, but I can actually add that. I probably should write that or get that one in there. I mean, there is a hidden Lion Salt already in the game, but I could add it to the menu, you know? All right, come on. It's actually a pretty good match, though, but I think Vince has the upper hand here. Oh, no. Okay, not climbing out. Wow.
It's what they came to see.
Please don't tell me the AI is blockheadish in this, man. Again, I can't remember the last time I watched a oh my god, AI escape only cage match. Nice Paul Burchill. Ooh, that stamina management's poor, my man.
And that's exactly what's happening here.
It's funny because I have like a notepad where I have like a somewhat accurate list of all the moves that were removed from SBR 10 to 11, and it's a lot. Like, you know, I always talk about it on stream, but like, I'm not exaggerating when I say they removed a lot of moves from that game. Combo! That's the Vince combo he won with! Ooh. He's out of stamina though. Tazz is down. He's not climbing. Oh, there he goes. Tazz, come on. You're my pick, man. Tazz, get up. Tazz! Tazz, no! Wake up! Oh, no. Vince McMahon gets the first match. Oh, no. Not looking good, man. Oh, come on. It's not over yet, but that's not good. All right, come on, Tazz. First blood match. Oh, Tazz. I forgot the damage retention. First blood may have been a mistake. Tazz is an orange head already. That didn't even cross my mind, the damage retention. I'm trying to think of their movesets, though. Like, Tazz has the mounted punches. That causes bloodshed. Does Vince have mounted punches, too? They could always... Weapons are another solid option. Oh, no. Dude, Vince is gonna win, isn't he? Come on.
He reversed it.
And, like, the computer is not necessarily smart enough to target the head, you know?
just imagining, Cole. These superstars have got a legitimate beef with each other.
Tazz is in the danger zone right now. That damage retention.
Here for sure.
And if this keeps
there you go. Come on. Stand the attack. Neck breaker. Target the head. Very nice. Come on. Spam those mounted punches. Well, there's another low blow. How many low blows this man dished out? But also, in the first blood matches, you can't pin. So if you try to pin, it actually does a move that would cause bloodshed. So you're not necessarily like screwed if you don't have like good moves, but I mean weapons and that are an option.
I'll tell you, anyone who thinks this business is a piece of cake, they should get in the ring with these superstars.
I don't think anyone would last too long.
Backbreaker, come on, Tazz. I got the bias here, man. I need that trifecta. Plus, I want to see that last man standing, to be honest with you. Ooh, JR's barbecue ribs coming into play. Tazz is a redhead. If Vince has any maneover that targets or that causes bloodshed, he's done. So like DDTs, mounted punches, or if he just goes for the pin. And if he grabs a weapon, he's donezo, man. Check your closet, Michael Cole. Michael Cole might have been the most disappointing performer in this tournament. We didn't get to see anything from him.
Boy, I'll tell you,
he played like an absolute blockhead. Could have been him and Tazz in the finals, man, all right? Actually, I don't know if that's true, because I don't know if he was like in a seed where that would be happening, but, you know. But also, you can kind of see, you can restore damage, like switch from red to an orange head by regaining stamina, but as soon as you get hit in that body part just one more time, it goes back to red. So it's somewhat useful, but not the greatest thing ever, you know.
With no signs of
stopping. All right, come on, Tess. Stay in the attack. Stay in the attack. Who cares about the stamina? Just stay in the attack. There you go. Hump handle? Okay. Interesting. Got him red, but we need that head red, man. Okay, Tess is going crazy now.
As soon as you let the slightest doubt into your mind, you can forget about it.
Oh no, Tazz, you gotta get up. Ooh! I thought he was gonna go for like the bloodshed maneuver.
Is just as impressive as the physical
sleeper,
condition.
Okay. Vince have a razor blade underneath his cufflinks or what? I'm surprised no one's gone for a weapon, to be honest with you. And someone said that in the chat too.
I knew it was only
especially Vince, because he's dirty.
I don't like it, but as long as it wins matches, it's going to.
Oh no.
That's the bottom
okay.
Line,
what was that? What was the point of that? Blockhead maneuver by Vince. Oh, Tazz, stamina, man. He's reeling. It let him do a maneuver. Oh my God.
Oh my God. There's a reason that's called a finishing move. The match usually doesn't go much longer.
Oh, they're both reeling on stamina. Oh. Robots are online. Vince bot, Tazz bot. And your Boston Crab in a first blood match. Very good. Very good.
Night after night, the
leg lock in a first blood match. Very nice,
never
very nice.
Fail to amaze the fans.
And that's a good thing, Cole. I don't ever want to think about where we'd be if they didn't.
Well, we wouldn't be sitting here calling.
Okay, he only got a little bit of stamina back there. Tazz, come on. Ooh, big reversal. Blockhead choice there. My man, you're going crazy. I know I said don't care about stamina, but this is a little too much. Straight left to the jaw. Come on. They're both reeling on the stamina.
Man, Cole, I don't want this match to end.
You don't want the match to end? You don't want to win, my dude?
Sooner or later.
Well, whichever way it goes, no one can say that these superstars didn't give it everything they got.
What a counter that was.
Okay, Tazz got a finisher here.
Well, the name of the game is to beat.
He does not have stamina, though. Can we get this man like a power raid or something? Electrolyte.
I don't think the fans
like. Oh, come on. Yeah. Oh, mounted punches. Do it again.
It should.
Do it again.
Look at this.
Oh, Tazz mission. Okay.
Well, damn right it is, Cole.
I want to see some mounted punches right after that. Oh, he's still only orange on the head. I'm shocked.
We've seen this before. He'll do whatever it takes
okay.
To win.
That took all your stamina, my man. I hope that was worth it. You gotta regain, my dude. You gotta regain. Okay, Tazz, he's kicking it up right now.
There you go. Oh.
I'll tell you, Cole, this is what the WWE is all about.
This is what it's all about.
The greatest athletes in the world competing on the grandest.
Dude, they're going back and forth. They both have good momentum, but bad stamina.
WWE superstars are all superb athletes, but they're all
even though I'm not a big fan of the stamina in this game, I love that sound effect. It's hilarious. And I left it on for the playthrough because of that, because it leads to some funny moments.
Good night, Irene.
Vince always loves to follow up after that. Come on, you gotta please tell me you have something that busts him open. Neck mounted punches. Do it! Oh, JR's barbecue ribs, and he's gonna have the stamina animation. Oh no. That's rough. That's rough luck right there.
We knew it was gonna be intense. We knew it was gonna be physical.
But he did the arm wrench behind and then left the ring. I guess to get some stamina.
I gotta admit, it kinda took me by surprise.
Okay, they're both getting stamina here, alright. Regroup.
You've been in hundreds of matches in your
career. Come on, Taz.
We both called hundreds more.
Vince doesn't know what to do here.
What to expect, but not this time.
Okay, he's hiding a bit. Still no weapons coming into play here.
Anything can happen here in the WWE.
Oh my god. Come on, Taz.
Victory means absolutely everything to these competitors tonight.
Thank you, Kevin.
Airplane spin. What is he going to follow up with this? He's got his head red.
Nobody wants
to. Oh, if only he had a chair near him. Oh! It's some Advil, the headache animation. Vince did not follow up, though.
Taz should spend more time calling the match and less time cutting down his
mount of punches, please. No, yeah, you blockhead. You could have won right there with the mounted punches, but you did the triangle hold.
Here it comes. Look out.
And then a Taz mission. Come on. You got to understand the circumstances you're in, man. Wow, he got up immediately from that. Come on, Taz. No! Okay, that edge clothesline thing. Okay, Taz is cooking right now.
Next Monday, Cole. Come on, Taz. I think we
please don't do the Taz mission. I feel like if he always has a finisher, he's always going to prioritize that Taz mission over the mounted punches. That's going to be a problem, I think, right? Okay, belly to belly from the top. Cost him his stamina. Was it worth it, my man?
WWE superstars are legit tough guys. But these
yeah, maybe him having
really
a finisher is actually putting him at a
tonight.
Disadvantage
they
here, because
sure
he's probably
going
to go for Taz mission before those mounted punches, man. Like, the AI doesn't, like, recognize these situations.
You gotta stand your opponent until one of you
okay,
Austin
stomps.
Anymore.
I think these superstars are well aware of that, Taz. I think that's exactly what
yeah, if we actually go to the match three, that last man standing is going to be interesting, because they're both going to be heavily damaged. That's going to be really bizarre. Ooh, JR's barbecue ribs coming into play. Taz does not follow up though. Blockhead maneuver.
They sure have, and that's where the superb conditioning of the.
Come on, is the ring bell over there? Get something.
No doubt, Cole.
Oh no.
You're gonna win a match if you're out of gas.
Oh no, Taz, Taz. Oh, Taz, come on, swing it, swing it. No, that's the wrong chair DDT. It busted him open, and he ran out of stamina. What a finish, Taz with a clutch reversal. Oh my god, we're going to match three. Oh my god, that was so clutch. That was do or die situation right there. Here we go. Last man standing, both heavily damaged. Here we go. Neckbreaker immediately. Taz, come on. That ending was insane. Oh my god. Here we go. Taz is cooking. He's cooking right now. Oh my god, we could see a quick minute victory here. He's cooking. Oh my god, what's for dinner, Taz? Because you're cooking up some good stuff right now. Oh my goodness. Jesus, dude. Taz is going crazy. Oh no, Vince, though. Oh no. Okay, here we go. Choke him out and. Oh, the Taz mission! Taz mission! Oh my goodness!
But these superstars are blowing me away right now.
He's out! Count ref! Oh my god, this could be it! Oh my god! Oh my god, we're gonna see a quick victory from Taz. My pick.
Talk about getting stuck with you as a
five
partner. Yeah, we'll talk about that
six about. Oh my god, no, he's up. Okay, crossface. All right, slow it. They're gonna slow it down, I guess, man. But that would have been insane, man. Taz was coming out firing right there. Oh my god, headache animation. Taz, you gotta follow up on that. You gotta take advantage.
And that's the name of the nice quick
neck breaker. No, reversed. Oh my, I can't get over that first blood finish. That was insane. Oh no.
want to keep
Tazz, he can't end on a Russian leg sweep, my man.
Two.
Not like this. Not three, this way, Tazz. Please.
Four.
You got to get up.
Five.
Looks like they might
you gotta have that fighting spirit. You gotta dig deep, please. Cole. Thank you.
The pace of the match may have slowed, but the intensity of these superstars certainly.
Dude, I'm also a little concerned. Last Man Standing will take forever in this game, like some of the other games. Oh my god, I'm still. I can't stop talking about it. That First Blood finish was literally insane. Like Tazz, he used all of his stamina for that, and like he countered the perfect point. Like that was. That was an you can't book that finish, man. That was insane.
This is one hell of a performance by some amazing superstars, Cole.
All right, yeah, some amazing super. Tazz putting himself over on the commentary. Oh no, big punch. All right, come on. Vince says, I'm scared. It might be wise just to run, Tazz, or do some leg locks to waste that finisher. No, the headache. Oh no.
Dangerous mindset to be
oh no. Didn't use the finisher. Wow, bold choice by Vince.
Risking your career for a single match.
Look, Boston Crab, all right.
Ballet. You got to go in there every single match and be willing to do whatever it takes. You'd know that if you actually stepped in between the
Yeah, so Tazz can actually bleed. Even if they in this game specifically, even if they don't have blood textures, the only requirement to bleed is to be labeled as a male in the game. So if you bleed, like the game still thinks you're bleeding. There's no blood on your actual face, just blood on the mat. It's not like Here Comes the Pain, for example, where if you don't have blood texture, regardless of your gender, you can't bleed. No, low blow! It's, oh no. No, Tazz, listen. I know you're damaged, I know you've been through two grueling matches, but you gotta get off. You gotta find something in there, you gotta dig deep, man. Oh, he gets him at four! This is gonna go on forever, isn't it? Oh, God. Oh, no. I mean, when I said I had nothing to do, I guess it's fine if it goes on forever. Hard Irish whip. All right. He's out from that. Could that be enough? Are we going to see a win from an Irish whip? Irish whip cream on the side? What are you doing, you psycho? He's down. Oh, my God. Was that worth the momentum? That was a bold choice by Tazz. And the Tazz mission gets countered, so that was for nothing. Oh, my God. That was the boldest thing I've ever seen.
You're absolutely right,
oh my God. I actually barely ever see the computer attack a downed opponent in a last man standing. Like when I say downed, I mean like flat counting. I don't really see that that often, I don't think. Oh my God.
We've seen this before. He'll do whatever it takes to win and take every
advantage. Oh my God.
Hey, no, that's not gonna make you popular, but you gotta
Tazz, come on, please. It can't end like this.
Dude,
I've said this like 40 times. I'm biased, man. I want that 3-for-3 pick, but you gotta get up.
Five.
He's up. He's
man,
up, folks.
These superstars. You
not done yet, man. We need some head arm Tazz flexes, some capture suplexes, man.
You sure can't. SmackDown's got the greatest superstars in the greatest matches.
Oh, that grapple was way off the mark.
In all of sports entertainment.
Big reversal from Vince. He's loving those jabs and
nice
boxing
reversal.
Hooks. They're effective, though. Palm handle, all right. All right, Tazz, listen, I know you're labeled clean, but I want to see you grab the steps, the chair, ring bell, something.
No kidding.
Whatever it takes
no matter
to win.
What call you make, you're going to get on the
Three.
Bad side of at least one
Four.
Superstar.
And that's
he picks him up. Tazz is
you're
crazy. He's
yourself.
Trying to make a statement here.
I know.
Oh, ring post? No, you could have done the environmental grapple, my man. Hey, Boston Crab.
I think we might be looking at... Watch it. He reversed it.
He reversed it. Okay, got a finisher here. Have I seen the AI grab the stairs in this game? Trying to think, man. I can't really remember. I'm sure I have, but in terms of like the rarity, maybe it is rare. I don't really remember. Oh, he got the rib animation, lost his finisher. You hate to see it. Oh, no.
All right,
you got to make him lose his finisher, man. Bust out that airplane spin. Long anim. Okay, here we go. He's going to get up fast, though, because he has the buff. Or he should, at least, right?
Look at these superstars go. It's
right?
Obvious they've done their homework
four.
On each other.
Right? Okay, four. I mean...
He saw that one
oh, no. He stored it. That had to have been close, man. Oh, my... Oh, I'm scared now. I'm spooked.
You never know what they
oh, no. Whoa, bro! He tried to punch him, but he missed. Oh, no. Oh no. Ladies and gentlemen, Vince is yelling at him. I think this is,
he's up already. Tazz is crazy. He hits it. Oh my god.
Human suplex machine, not really using that many suplexes, man. He's expanding the repertoire, I suppose. Oh, that's a good point. When Vince does a low blow, the ref's stuck in that yelling animation. I didn't even think about that. It's true, yeah. Tazz could have the advantage. And for some reason, Vince won't use his secondary finisher. He keeps doing the primary one. Oh no, hard Irish whip though.
I'll tell you, anyone who thinks this business is a piece of cake, they should get in the
ring
with these.
Oh my god, we really gonna see a finish from an Irish whip.
Would last too long against them. These are trained.
Just staring him down like a creep. Tazz, get up. Think about your fans out there. Oh no. Oh no, Tazz. Ooh, had me scared, man. I think seven's the highest count we've seen so far, right?
Not the way I thought this match was gonna go at all.
Low blow from Vince. This man will do whatever it takes to win. Oh, Tazz is out.
Know exactly what you're going to see.
Two.
Tazz, listen. I said this like five times now, but you gotta dig deep. You gotta find something, man. There you go. Big reversal immediately too. Good. Snap jab. All right. One of the quickest moves in the game. Very reliable, I would say. It's Tazz! Dude, that beginning minute sequence of this match, though, was crazy. Tazz was going wild in Tazz's mission. If that would have been the finish, that would have been crazy. It was too good to be true, though. That was insanity, man.
And there's the counter, Cole.
There you go. Man, Vince is ruthless, though.
This one could still go either way.
Got the falling animation.
It's not over until
why is Tazz not utilizing his... Oh, no. Oh, he stored instead of using it. Interesting choice. Kind of surprised Vince hasn't grabbed a... Oh, wait a minute. He's yelling at him. He's yelling at him. Listen, pal, you need to stay down, pal.
Neither do I, Tazz. And I think it's that unpredictability that makes it so exciting.
No doubt, Cole.
Why does Tazz have a dropkick to the knee? I really don't know.
And still lose the match because
I haven't seen him bust out a capture suplex yet either. I'm sure it's on his movesets, alright.
One or two big moves,
like a hard Irish whip. Okay, camera change. We're getting up the ramp a bit. No!
Oh my god.
Yeah, yell at him. Yell at him. Vince is going for a weapon. Oh, sledgehammer. Triple H put that there. Is he going to swing or just wait?
Three.
He put it down and went for a grapple. Wow, that was... Why?
So unpredictable. I'm having a hard time figuring
out... Ooh, the sledgehammer comes into play. It blocks the Irish whip.
I don't think you're going to be able
to... Neckbreaker reversed. Okay, Vince, man. Vince is in control here.
What a wild ride it's been so far.
He's in control, man.
No signs of stopping anytime soon. What a reversal.
What a Paul Burchill. Tazz, man, I need to see more Tazz plexes, man. That's your problem right now. You opened up so strong, but now you're just kind of... There, come on, grapple.
Man, even if you
there we go.
Like this,
there we go.
The week.
Oh, he's out. Yes, Tazz got the rib animation. You better not pick him up, Tazz. Stop being a psycho, man.
As well as physical pain, is that much worse?
Is one suplex enough? He's out on the red carpet right now. No, he's up. He's up, folks. We're taking this upstage, alright.
You can literally feel the disappointment.
Here we go. Head arm Tazz flex. We're cooking now. Vince is out again.
One. Two.
Look at Vince's face right there.
Three. Four.
You gonna store that, my dude? Okay, there you go.
They sure are.
Six.
And I don't think they're going to be put out anytime
soon. Seven?
Eight?
That's a new highest count.
Nine.
Oh, he's up at nine. Oh my god, I could taste the victory. It was so close, dude. Oh my god. Tazz mission reverse. No. Oh my god, he was so close to winning, dude. I can't believe Vince got up. We're brawling on the red carpet. WrestleMania going Hollywood right now.
To go the distance.
I can't believe he got up from that, dude.
That's for sure, partner. There's always someone.
Dude, my bias is strong in this match for my pick, man.
Can't keep up.
And I'm not ashamed to admit it. It's the truth, man. I want Tazz to win for my pick.
And barbecue and ribs animation. So
it's even worth sitting next to you to watch it, Cole.
Good stamina recovery to get that damage down a bit in case he gets up.
My number one choice for a broadcast partner either.
You know what you should do, girl?
Okay, he's up at five that time.
Alright,
listen, Taz, I know you're clean, but I need you to go against your AI, pick up that sledgehammer, and just swing away, my man. A joker like you? Oh, sledgehammer blocks another Irish whip.
Look at that.
Oh, jawbreaker thing. Oh, he's out. No, come on. Taz! We can't see his eyes through the sunglasses, man.
Four. Five.
Oh no.
Six.
He's up. Immediate reversal too. That's a statement. Listen, those Tazz flexes have been pretty successful in terms of how long he stayed down. You need to bust him out some more, my man. A little bit of a drop kick there. Dude, they're just brawling on the stage. They're not moving. This is crazy.
That's for sure, Tazz. And the number one rule here.
Oh, Vince choking him out. Come on. Oh, he got up immediately. Or no, he reversed, I think, actually. Irish whip. Not blocked with a sledgehammer this time. Yeah, the sledgehammer's there. We can't forget about that. That could be an X factor later in the match if one of them goes for it. Oh, no. Sleeper. Actually, that doesn't matter because in the seated position, you can't be counted out. Or counted down, I guess. There you go.
You gotta understand, Cole. I know it ain't exactly kosher. But you're putting your body on the line in there. You gotta
Whoa, dropkick again. That's been pretty successful for Vince so far.
Taz, you're talking about two different things. Going outside the rules in the name of
Is he gonna store that or waste it?
But cheating to steal a victory?
Cheating to steal a victory? You know what? Do it. I approve. Vince has been doing low blows all match. Okay, we're back in the ring now. Stamina up pretty good right now. They're both in the green zone. Vince's got a little bit more, though. Another drop kick from Vince, man. And a leg drop when he's clearly, like, 10 feet away.
The first time you've made a prediction that didn't pan out.
That's pretty funny.
Big reversal, all right.
You keep up with your mouth, you're gonna have a permanent limp.
Damn. Taz mission reversed again. Wow. We've had a lot of reverse Taz missions this match. Environmental grapple from Vince into low blow. What a combo. Oh my god, but he does a strike right after. Blockhead maneuver by Vince McMahon. That was a good combo. That could have been it, but he did a blockhead maneuver. Struck him down, canceling the flat animation and back suplex by Taz. Oh my god. That was another Vince McMahon combo like we saw in the cage match, dude. And we're back in the ring now. Vince is running, though. Wow, what a combo, dude.
I'm just gonna keep my mouth shut.
Wow, if I knew it was that easy, said that years ago.
A lot of reversals here. They're both down to momentum. Oh, Vince. Oh, no. Here we go. Here we go. Oh, Taz is ready, though. That's shades of the last match. Remember what happened last time? Does Vince really want to try that again with the chair? Taz was ready, man. But I feel like Taz isn't going to use it because he's clean, but you never know, I suppose. Okay, Samoan drop. Is that enough? Hasn't been successful in the past, but this could change.
I don't think I've ever seen a superstar win a match by being a tackling dummy.
Five.
Vince is up. Low blow. That's how it feels, Vince. Turning the tables here.
He certainly is. And I hope he's proud of himself. Personally, I find it disgusting.
Disgusting. I approve, dude. You see what Vince has been doing, man? This whole tournament, man. Some could argue Vince shouldn't even be here because Red technically won that cage match when he got out of the cage but when I left that cheat on by accident. there's an argument for that, all right? But at the end of the day, the game declared Vince the winner, so it's out of my control.
It's really tough to live up to the expectations, but these superstars ain't having any trouble doing that.
They sure aren't, and that's an impressive thing.
All right, come on. That head-on Tazz flex got him a 9. Oh, no!
Cole.
Low blow. No.
Right,
what are the One. Stats of Vince and Taz? The overalls, I believe, Taz 85, Vince 77.
Jeez,
I don't
match.
Know the
four.
Like specific
no
like strength stats and stuff.
Next.
Taz is up at 4. Wow.
And I think that's one of the things that
oh no, the
so
chair.
Exciting.
Oh boy, Taz grabbed that. Shades of the last match. Oh my God, he's buzzed. Oh, is this it?
That was a stiff chair shot to the head, busted him open. Oh no, Vince is gonna redeem himself in the first blood match. Oh no.
Maybe so, but I'm more concerned about the risk to his
well-being now that he's eight. Oh no, nine. Vince McMahon has redeemed himself in the first blood match by busting Taz open. Gets the win and wins the entire tournament. Taz has made me fail my predictions. I was 2 for 3 now. Oh my god, the finish. Look at that. That's the face of the, apparently, according to this game or this tournament simulation, the best NPC in SVR 06. No chance. Oh my god. I can't believe it, man. The chair, the callback to the last match. No chance. Vince McMahon, your winner of the SVR 06 Non-Playable Characters Tournament. Alright, well, here's your final tournament bracket here. Been through it all, but Vince McMahon comes out on top, dude. Unbelievable. Here are those standings real quick. Vince McMahon up top, man. Dude, that was a wild tournament.